So, hello everyone, good evening, and welcome to the one shot of Filmology. I hope I can see the energy, and I think you people are writing right ki jab tak hai ja tab tak karte rahenge, and we will try to revise each and every important topic of ophthalmology. Now be very very
good
clear.
Evening.
My goal here is not to do the each and every word of ophthalmology, but yes, jitna chahiye utna padhenge, and we will make sure that no question of ophthalmology gets wrong on 5th of March. So be ready for the ophthalmology ride. And I know you people were asking about the PDF, so don't worry, I will just blanket the PDF just after the session, okay? Because I'll explain you the points and then I want you to get the PDF. So be sure that just after the session, your PDF is in tech with me. I will blink it to you. So are we ready? Yes. No. Yeah. Okay. So I can... Thank you so much. So thank you so much. People are giving so many good comments, and I can feel your energy, and that energy is actually coming to me. So I am very very excited, and I hope that we remain this much energetic, this much motivated, and this much inspired throughout the session, though I am not planning to prolong it much, because you know, if you take it very very long, the whole idea of revision gets wrong. I want that you should be able to revise ophthalmology so that after this session, you know, that just revise this and you are done. So I want to make it very very crisp and concise. All right, okay, so shuru karte hain, yeah, without a further ado. And with every topic, I will say 1, 2, I will give the number, and we will be covering those many questions. So all the questions of the ophthalmology, let's hope, are going to be from the topics that we are covering today. Okay. All right. So the first one, let us start with the first one. That is the visual acuity. You can all see this. And guys, I will be going faster. What you are required to do is that you can jot down the things along with me, or whatever you notes you are having, you can just keep on revising that, because after the session you are going to get the PDF. So just sit back, listen to me and revise with me, and after this session you are going to get the PDF. Okay, yes, but if something here and there you want to write along with me, then you can write it on a just piece of paper, nothing much, because after the session you will be getting whole of the PDF. Okay, so let's start the topic number one, the visual acuity, and right in front of me you can see the Snellen's chart. Okay, so the Snellen's chart ka important things, the first, what is the distance? The distance of the patient from the chart is 6 meters, or it is 20 feet. So the normal visual acuity will be 6 by 6 or 20 by 20. Be very, very clear. Okay, so 6 is in meters and 20 is in feet. So either in India, we take it in meters, so it is 6 by 6. In US, we take it in feet, so it is 20 by 20. Very, very clear. All right, now coming to this much. Okay, so coming to this much, now what is the topmost line? Topmost line, if the patient is able to read, we are going from 6 by 60. Next line, 6 by 36, 6 by 24, 6 by 18, 6 by 12, 6 by 9, and 6 by 6. So our goal is from 6 by 60 to 6 by 6. Okay, now let's take the distance. What is the meaning of 6 by 60? That is the most important thing. So 6 is the numerator and here 60 is the denominator. What is the meaning of 6 here? 6 is the distance of the patient from the chart. We always ask the patient to stand at a distance of 6 meters. And what is 60? What a normal person can read from 60 meters. This person is reading from 6 meters. This is the basic concept that we have taken from it. And now I want all of you. And now I want all of you to sit back and we will do the numerical orally. Because in exam, we are going to do it orally. So let's do the numerical orally. Be reminded of the minimum angle of resolution. We always take the E of the E Gurukul. So whenever we are going to read this letter E, what should be the minimum angle that should be subtended at the nodal point? Okay, that is the 5 minutes of the arc. Minimum angle of resolution made by any Lead letter at the nodal point. Nodal point means 6 meters. Is the 5 minutes of the arc. So on the basis of this, we are going to do the questions. Now always remember one thing, that each letter of the Snellen's chart makes the same angle, that is 5 minutes, at the nodal point, and nodal point will be at the 6 meters. Now whenever they are asking you a question something like this, because I'm going to revise all the PYQs till 2017, so you will not need to go through even the PYQs of ophthalmology. That is the best part of it. So you get the question, what is the angle subtended by the topmost letter of the Snellen's chart at the nodal point of the eye? So at the nodal point of the eye means it will be 6 meters, and this angle will be how much? They are asking about the topmost letter. So always remember that each letter was making this angle, that is 5 minutes, at the respective distance. Now respective distance means if I talk about 6 by 60, then the respective distance is 60 meters. So it will make 5 minutes at the 60 meters, and therefore what will be the angle at 6 meters? Now obviously when the person is going closer to the letter, distance is decreasing, so angle will increase. How much we are going closer to the letter? So because we are going closer to the letter 10 times, therefore angle will also increase by 10 times. Now this much maths we all students know, that 60 upon 6 is 10 times. So 10 times angle will increase. Therefore what will be the answer? 5 minutes into 10, 50 minutes. So orally you have to do, you don't have to panic, just fractions of the seconds may you can get the answer. If the same question they are asking for 6 by 36, so that means 5 minutes will be made at the respective distance, and now the respective distance is 36. So at 36 meters it is 5 minutes, and at 6 therefore, so how much closer we are coming? From 36 to 6, therefore 6 times. 5 into 6, 30 minutes. If I ask you 6 by 24, so from 24 to 6, 4 times. 5 into 4, 20 minutes. And finally we are coming from 2 6 by 18. So from 18 meters to 6 meters, therefore this is 3 times. Therefore 5 into 3, 15 minutes. So this is the maximum thing that you need to know about the visual acuity. What is the concept of minimum angle of resolution and how to do that numerical, starting from the topmost letter to 6 by 6 letter. And this time they have asked you the most simple one. The angle subtended by 6 by 6 letter. This is the recent INICET examination. And I have told you this in classes also, that this is the best mock paper for you guys. This is the best mock paper and you all have to do. So I am making sure that we are going to do all the questions of this INSET November 2022 ophthalmology. They have asked you just the 6x6 letter. So 6x6 letter ka respective distance is 6. Therefore, the distance from the 6 meters will be only 5 minutes. Any question related to visual acuity and the Snellen's chart along with the minimum angle of resolution along with the numerical, you are going to do it. So this is your first thing. This is your first thing. And second, we will go towards the lens. Now, as you know, lens is the most important part and we cannot have a paper without the lens question. So let's see some of the important things, all the important images also I have tried to incorporate. So when I talk about the lens, okay, always remember ABCD of the lens. So we will try to make sure that we will learn in the session itself. So let's see, we have got A, we have got B and we have got C as well as D. So what is ABCD guys? A for avascular lenses, avascular, B for biconvex, the shape is actually biconvex, C for crystalline, it is having the crystallines, and then we have D for dehydrated, we are having the dehydrated state of the lens. So just remember A for avascular, B for biconvex, C for crystallines and D for dehydrated. And what type of dehydration? It is actually relative dehydration. Relative, that means a delicate balance is maintained inside the lens. If you are going towards dehydration, then also we will have cataract. If I am going towards overhydration, then also we are having the cataract. Another important thing, you can see there are two parts of the lens. We have nucleus and we have the cortex, and we have got these concentric layers inside the lens. So this is actually called as the concentric lamellae. These are called as the concentric lamellae. So basically the structure of the lens is present in the form of the layers. Okay. So just remember ABCD of the lens and we are done with it. Okay. Now, whenever we have talked about the anatomy of the lens, you know the fibers, avascularity, the crystallines. Talking about the metabolic activity, so always remember that the metabolism which is present in the lens is more than 80%, it is anaerobic glycolysis. It is anaerobic glycolysis, and due to this glycolysis, lot of free radicals, and these free radicals will be taken up by the antioxidative stress. So antioxidative mechanism is again an important thing which is present inside the lens. We have an antioxidative mechanism, and this antioxidative mechanism consists of the beta carotenoids. We have got the precursor of vitamin A. Just a second. Yeah, so we have got the beta carotenoids, that is the precursor of vitamin A, along with the vitamin B, vitamin C and vitamin E. Very, very important AIIMS question, and they can ask you the all except question, or they can ask you the direct also, that which vitamin is involved. Now, having been done this, we are coming to the types of the cataract. So all the important pictures guys, please see, this one is the most important. You can see the bluish opacities, punctate opacities present inside the lens. So this is actually the most common congenital or the developmental cataract, called as blue dot cataract. So as the name signifies, this is a blue dot cataract because we have bluish opacities, punctate opacities, small opacities, and that is why this is not visually significant. So another important question, if they ask you the most common but that is visually significant also, then that will be a different one. The most common which is visually significant also, there comes this laminar cataract, also called as zonular cataract or the rider's cataract, because the opacities resembles the spokes of cycle wheel appearance. So never get confused when they ask you most common congenital as well as most common congenital, which is visually significant also. Now coming to the third one, we have the total congenital cataract. So all of you remember the Todd's group of infections. Todd's group of infections may we have the toxoplasmosis, we have others, we have got rubella, we have cytomegalovirus and we have herpes. So this rubella can cause the congenital rubella syndrome. Now congenital rubella syndrome will involve three organs. We have got eye, we have got ear and we have heart. So what are the things that we have in eye? We have the congenital cataract. And what is the DD of congenital cataract called as? Because you know, whenever we talked about the clinical subject, it is very, very important to talk about the DD. So we will have what you call as the leukochorea. The first important DD is the leukochorea. Then we can have the salt and pepper retinitis. And third is the microphthalmos. Then in the ear, we have the sensorineural hearing loss. And in the heart, very, very important is the PDA. So basically multiple questions can be asked from this congenital rubella syndrome. We can have very, very important salt and pepper retinitis, DD of leukochorea, DD of the microphthalmos, DD of sensorineural hearing loss as well as PDA, and always remember ASD is never found. So many times we have got the PYQs. ASD is never found here. So always remember this. Another very, very important thing. Can you see? I have always shown you that onion ring appearance. So we get that typical onion ring appearance in cases of the posterior polar cataract. So we have a cataract on the anterior pole also. We can have a cataract on the posterior pole also. So how to read the slit lamp section? If you see, this is the cornea, the anterior convexity and the biconvexity. This one is the lens. Now the thing which is towards the cornea will be the anterior surface, and the thing which is away from the cornea, this will be the posterior and this will be the posterior pole. So if you are getting a ring like appearance just at the posterior pole, that will be called as the onion ring appearance found in the posterior polar cataract. Posterior polar cataract. Okay, this is blurred. I will show you the other thing. Okay, I suppose this is fine now. So you can see this is the posterior pole, and at the posterior pole, you can see at the posterior pole, we are having the typical, you are getting this posterior polar cataract called as the onion ring appearance, a direct PYQ. Okay. Now see another slit lamp section, because you can get the slit lamp sections in the exam. This one is again the cornea, the anterior convexity, and this with biconvex is the lens. What you can see here is the golden brown color. So golden brown color is the pigment deposition in the nucleus. Therefore, this is the nuclear sclerosis. We can have two kind of cataract. We can have nuclear cataract and we can have cortical cataract. In the nucleus, we are having the central pigmentation. So this is your nuclear sclerosis. Another important thing, we can have two kind of cortical cataract. So first of all, when we have the peripheral opacities in the wedge-shaped opacities in the periphery, this is actually the cuneiform. This is the cuneiform type of cataract. While another one, there where we have got the plaque-like opacity in the center. This is called as cupuliform type of cataract, which is also called as posterior subcapsular cataract. So we can have congenital, we can have acquired, we can have cortical, we can have nuclear. And in the cortical, I can have two types. One is the cuneiform type of cataract and another is the cupuliform, which is the central cataract. Okay. Now write in the comment section that which cataract will present as the day blindness and which cataract will present as the night blindness. Till then, I'm going to tell you all the important causes of the posterior subcapsular cataract, because that is again an important one. It is the most handicapping type of cataract. So remember in the morning, I got a BSc. I got a BSc. I for ionizing radiations. Then we have got the G for glass blower's cataract, which is occurring due to the infrared radiations. Then we have atopic dermatitis. This is causing the shield cataract. This is causing the shield cataract. Then busulfan hai, steroids hai, S for steroids and C for chloroquine. So I got a BSc whole of the mnemonic to get all the causes of the posterior subcapsular cataract. Very correct. So cuneiform type of cataract will be the giving you the peripheral one, and therefore it will give you night blindness, while cupuliform is presenting as the day blindness because it is the central cataract. Very, very correct. So we have all the causes of the posterior subcapsular cataract. Now after this we come to the stages of maturation. So stages of maturation of the cortical cataract, it will start, always remember, from the lamellar separation. It is always starting from the lamellar separation because of the overhydration. Then will be the early cataract, and after the early cataract we will have immature cataract, then is the mature cataract, and finally we will have hypermature cataract. So whenever we have excess of overhydration, this can lead to the separation of the layers called as lamellar separation. Then starts the early cataract, means the cataract opacification starts, and this early cataract actually will lead to the uniocular polyopia. Uniocular polyopia. Then another important thing for the immature cataract will be the iris shadow. We are going to have the iris shadow present in immature. Most important, in the mature senile cataract, we will have diminution of vision. Now the colors are again very, very important. First of all, in the immature cataract, we are going to have the grayish white color. Then in the mature cataract, we will have the pearly white color. And in the hypermature cataract, we are going to have the chalky white color. So in order to differentiate whether it is a immature cataract or it's a mature cataract, we are going to see this iris shadow and look at the colors also. Like if you see here, if you see this mature cataract, this will be pearly white in color. So this is a mature cataract. Now what I told you, whenever we have the mature cataract, the most important thing that we are going to have is the diminution of vision. And whenever we have the diminution of vision, you are going to ask three things: whether it is sudden, or whether it is gradual, whether it is painless or it is painful, and third is whether it is stationary or whether it is progressive. So always see the more than the these things, it is important how to approach the question. So whenever you get the question in the exam on the diminution of vision, always start from here: whether it is sudden, whether it is gradual, whether it is painless or it is painful, whether it is stationary or whether it is progressive. So can you tell me in cases of cataract what you are going to get? Can you tell me what type of vision loss you are going to get in the cataract? So we are going to get the gradual, we are going to get painless, and we are going to get the progressive one. So whenever we are getting the gradual, painless, progressive diminution of vision, always remember what can be the DDs. Therefore, whenever we have the gradual, painless, progressive diminution of vision, simple maths, that means in the answer either is the cataract or your answer is the primary open angle glaucoma. As simple as that. If you are having a gradual, painless, progressive diminution of vision, either your answer is cataract or your answer is glaucoma. Now after reading that much of ophthalmology, I hope you will be able to recognize whether it's a question of cataract or it's a question of glaucoma. So simple, you are not going to do anything wrong in that question. You know that this will be a male or a female with a gradual, painless, progressive diminution of vision, will either be cataract or it is glaucoma. Now you can see the two kinds of hypermature cataract. One is the liquefaction of the cortex. So what will happen? The nucleus will settle at the bottom. Because of the lysis of the cortex, nucleus settle at the bottom. So because there is a lysis, what will be the type of glaucoma? Because there is a lysis of the cortex here, therefore we are going to get the phacolytic glaucoma. So what type of glaucoma here we can have is the phacolytic. While in cases of immature, what was happening? There was a overhydration of the lens. So there was a change in the morphology of the lens. When there is a change in the morphology of the lens, that will lead to phacomorphic glaucoma. While here there is a lysis of the cortex, therefore there will be phacolytic glaucoma. The other type is the sclerotic type. In the sclerotic type, we have the disintegration. Because here we are having the disintegration of the cortex. So there is small size, whole of the fluid is going out. So what will happen? Lens will start moving here and there. Therefore, this will have the lens subluxation. Therefore, this is going to have the subluxation of the lens. So all the stages of the cortex, starting from the lamellar separation, then we have the early cataract, immature, mature and hypermature cataract. All right. Now let's see the other important types of cataracts. You start writing in the comment section, you can see this is the star shaped cataract. So whenever we have this star shaped cataract, this is actually called as the rosette cataract, and this rosette cataract is caused by the blunt trauma. Now blunt trauma is another topic that I'm sure that you are going to have in your exam. All the important signs of blunt trauma you are going to get. So the type of cataract that you get is actually the rosette cataract or the star-shaped cataract. And another type of cataract here you can get is the floral pattern. So this floral pattern is actually the sunflower cataract. Sunflower cataract is occurring by which trauma? It is the penetrating trauma. Now guys, also tell me, what is the difference between penetrating trauma and the perforating trauma? Blunt trauma gives you rosette cataract, while penetrating trauma gives you the sunflower cataract. Another important question that you are going to have in your exam. Number one was visual acuity. Number two was blunt trauma. Number three is this. What is this? This is the KF ring. This is actually the KF ring. 2023, I am writing without a doubt. You are going to have a question on this on 5th of March. KF ring found in the Wilson's disease. So we all know about the Wilson's disease, hepatolenticular degeneration. We are going to have copper deposition, and due to the copper deposition, the same we are going to have, that is the sunflower cataract. Therefore, we are going to have the sunflower cataract, and we were having the question in the INSET November 2022 that how many patients with the liver manifestations can have KF ring. So if the patient is having the liver manifestations, it is just 50 to 55%, but if the patient is having the CNS manifestations, 90 to 95% will have the KF ring. Where it is first present? It is first present in the superior and inferior quadrant. So take my words, whether you read the Wilson's disease in patho, medicine, ophtha, wherever, combine these things, you are going to get one question on the Wilson's disease and the KF ring on 5th of March. Very, very important. Yes. So penetrating means penetrating trauma. Penetrating trauma means only the entry wound. But when we have entry wound and exit wound both, then that is actually called as the perforating trauma, and it is present in the Desmond's membrane. Yes, all right. Now see the beautiful cloudy opacity. So what is this? This is actually the snowflake cataract, and snowflake cataract is found in the diabetes. Now another important thing, please consider that it is not the most common cataract in the diabetes. Moreover, the type of cataract which is present here will be the true metabolic cataract. So we get two important questions here. What is the enzyme involved? Enzyme involved is the aldole reductase enzyme, and the pathway involved is the sorbitol pathway. These are the two important things about the diabetes, and always remember, it is the not most common cataract. Then what is the most common cataract found in diabetes? Actually, it is the प्री सेनाइल कैटरेक्ट. एग्जैक्टली इट इज द प्री सेनाइल कैटरेक्ट विच इज फाउंड. नाउ सी द ब्यूटिफुल ब्यूटिफुल इट इज द ऑयल ड्रॉपलेट कैटरेक्ट. दिस इज द ऑयल ड्रॉपलेट कैटरेक्ट. यू कैन सी एज ब्यूटिफुल एज अ ड्रॉप एंड वेयर यू आर गोइंग टू गेट इट. दिस इज अ वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन गाइज. टेक माई वर्ड, यू आर गोइंग टू गेट वन क्वेश्चन from these other cases of acquired cataract. So it is the only cataract which is actually reversible. Only cataract which is reversible is this oil droplet cataract. Now whenever we have the classical galactosemia, what is classical galactosemia? This is actually what you call it, because you are not going to have the direct question. So this is your ophtha plus peds plus the biochemistry also. This is the biochem also, ophtha plus pediatrics along with the biochemistry. You are going to have this question. A baby will come with leukocoria. And you will see that in the exam, you will hear my words. See, this is a child having leukocoria. Pediatrics may, it can have seizures. It can have the seizures. Biochemistry may, it can have hepatosplenomegaly. Hepatosplenomegaly in exam. These pictures are damn blurry. Pictures may be blurring, but what happens, beta? You will get something in the question also. Now, one important thing, whenever you get an image-based question, whenever you get the image-based question, now what is the sequence you have to follow? The sequence is first see the image, then you have to see the options, and then you have to read the question. Always go in this order. First, you have to see the image, then you have to see the options, and then you have to read the question. Now, let me tell you why. Because when you read the question, there is something that is coming in your mind. Then you see the image, then there is another thing that comes to your mind. And then you see the options, actually there is third thing that is coming in your mind. So basically, you are wasting your lot of time. While if you see the image, it will click you, because images you have seen. Then you see the options that can confirm that image. Now having that thing in your mind, you read the question, you will get to know what is there. Otherwise, you will have to read the question again. So very, very important. My pics are so clear. Obviously, अगर clear देख रखा है तो blurry पहचान लोगे. अगर blurry ही मैं दिखाऊंगी तो clear भी नहीं पहचान पाओगे. So that's a simple funda. I am showing you the most beautiful pictures. You may not get that beautiful pictures in the exam, but be ready. ठीक है ना? कोई बात नहीं है. अगर मुझे देखा हुआ है तो मेरी blurry picture से भी मुझे पहचान लोगे. But अगर मेरी picture blurry देखी हुई है तो मेरी clear picture से भी मुझे नहीं पहचान पाओगे. वेरी सिंपल फंडा है. और जब भी इमेज बेस्ड क्वेश्चन आएगा, पहले इमेज देखनी है, फिर ऑप्शन देखने है. और दिस इज नॉट ओनली फॉर ऑप्थल्मोलॉजी, एवरी सब्जेक्ट, मतलब एनाटॉमी का हो, रेडियो का हो, ईएनटी का हो, किसी भी सब्जेक्ट का हो, आई एम टेलिंग यू कि आप पहले आप इमेज देखो, ऑप्शंस पढ़ो, उसके बाद क्वेश्चन देखो. अदरवाइज पूरा का पूरा एक्सरसाइज दोबारा करना पड़ेगा एंड यू विल हैव टू रीड द क्वेश्चन अगेन. तो दैट विल गो. ठीक है ना? तो दैट इज वेरी वेरी सिंपल. तो खैर, तो हम लोग बात कर रहे थे इस बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक का. वी वर हैविंग द ऑफ्थ पीडियाट्रिक एंड बायोकेमिस्ट्री. ल्यूकोकोरिया है, सीजर्स है, हेपेटोस्प्लेनोमेगैली है, एंड अलोंग विद दिस यू आर ऑल्सो गोइंग टू गेट द फेलियर टू थ्राइव. सो व्हेनेवर यू आर गेटिंग एनी चाइल्ड हु इज नॉट एबल टू ग्रो, हैविंग हेपेटोस्प्लेनोमेगैली, having features of intolerance, then it is actually classical galactosemia, and then you will see the picture also, oil droplet cataract hoga, you will get this. Okay. Why I am so cute, I do not know actually, but the thing is that you find me cute, that is good enough. Now see this, this is actually the shield cataract. Shield cataract mein plaque like jaisa hai. तो प्लाक मतलब एक पूरा लेयर जैसी लगेगी, है ना? जरूरी नहीं है दैट यू गेट द सिमिलर पिक्चर, बट वेर एवर यू आर नॉट गेटिंग एनीथिंग एंड यू गेट अ प्लाक लाइक कवरिंग ऐसा मिल रहा है, तो शील्ड कैटरेक्ट हो गया. ऑयल ड्रॉपलेट जैसा मिलेगा, क्लाउडी ओपेसिटीज मिल गई इन केसेस ऑफ स्नोफ्लेक कैटरेक्ट. ठीक है, इसको याद रखना. व्हाट आई एम टेलिंग यू, पिक्चर के साथ मैं क्या बोल रही हूँ वो भी याद रखना है. केएफ रिंग सब पे चल लेंगे, बट प्रॉब्लम ये है कि क्वेश्चन पढ़ लेना. समटाइम्स दे आस्क यू व्हाट इज एक्चुअली एसोसिएटेड with KF ring, and 2018 mein aisa hua tha, they had given this question and answer was associated with the low levels of ceruloplasmin, and all the students had actually marked the KF ring. So please read the question, don't guess the question. Question is right in front of you, usko padhna bhi hai. Uske baad hamare paas रोजेट कैटरेक्ट है और सनफ्लावर कैटरेक्ट है. रोजेट कैटरेक्ट स्टार जैसा होगा, सनफ्लावर कैटरेक्ट फ्लावर जैसा होगा. इफ यू आर अगेन कंफ्यूज, जस्ट काउंट द नंबर ऑफ पेटल्स. रोजेट कैटरेक्ट में नंबर ऑफ पेटल्स कितनी होंगी? ओनली 5 to 6 पेटल्स होगी. वाइल इन केसेस ऑफ द सनफ्लावर कैटरेक्ट कितनी पेटल्स होंगी? 9 to 10 होंगी. तो ब्लरी होगा तब भी यू विल बी एबल टू रीड द काउंट द पेटल्स. सो प्लीज प्लीज काउंट द पेटल्स. आवाज नहीं आ रही गाइज, कांट यू हियर मी? मुझे अपनी बहुत तेज आवाज आ रही है. अच्छा, नाउ सी दिस, अनदर क्वेश्चन ऑफ द इनसेट एग्जामिनेशन. अनदर क्वेश्चन ऑफ इनसेट एग्जामिनेशन November 2022. इसीलिए बिकॉज आई एम गोइंग टू रिवाइज ऑल द इनसेट क्वेश्चन ऑल्सो. मैंने बोल भी दिया था कि डोंट वेस्ट योर टाइम इन रिवाइजिंग ऑफ्थेल्मोलॉजी, वी विल रिवाइज इट टूगेदर. ठीक है ना? सो नॉट ट्रू इन द कॉम्प्लिकेटेड कैटरेक्ट. वॉट इज कॉम्प्लिकेटेड कैटरेक्ट? As the name suggests, which is occurring as a complication. So it most commonly occurs as a complication of uveitis. Always it is occurring as chronic anterior uveitis. आ रही है मैम ना? हाँ क्रिस्टल, मतलब मैं बहुत जोर से बोल रही हूँ और माइक भी बहुत अच्छा है. इट इज ड्यू टू द क्रोनिक एंटीरियर यूवियाइटिस. अब टेक माई वर्ड्स की एक क्वेश्चन 2023 में आने वाला है ऑन द क्रूकेनबर्ग स्पिंडल्स या फिर पिगमेंट्री ग्लॉकोमा. ठीक है ना? तो एक मैंने विजुअल एक्विटी बता दिया था, उसके बाद ब्लंट ट्रॉमा भी हमने बोला, केएफ रिंग बोला, एंड वन इमेज ऑफ द अदर्स टाइप ऑफ एक्वायर्ड कैटरेक्ट, जिसमें से एक ये भी है क्रूकेनबर्ग स्पिंडल्स दी सेकेंडरी ग्लॉकोमास. तो वो भी हम अभी जाएंगे. कॉम्प्लिकेशन ऑफ द ऑकुलर डिजीजेस, मोस्ट कॉमनली क्रोनिक एंटीरियर यूवियाइटिस, जिसके दो इंपॉर्टेंट फीचर्स हैं. क्या दो इंपॉर्टेंट फीचर्स होते हैं जो इसमें दे रखे हैं? पॉलीक्रोमेटिक लस्टर एंड द ब्रेड क्रम्ब अपियरेंस. पॉली मीन्स मैनी, क्रोमा मीन्स कलर, एंड लस्टर मतलब शाइनी रिफ्लेक्सेस. सो यू आर गोइंग टू गेट पॉलीक्रोमेटिक लस्टर एंड द ब्रेड क्रम्ब अपियरेंस. देयरफॉर आंसर क्या हो जाएगा? क्रूकेनबर्ग स्पिंडल्स. वो कहाँ मिलते हैं? क्रूकेनबर्ग स्पिंडल्स आर फाउंड इन द पिगमेंट्री ग्लॉकोमा. And that we will discuss in, that we are going to discuss in the glaucoma. तो यहां से चलते हैं. इससे ज्यादा ब्यूटिफुल कैटरेक्ट नहीं होता आई थिंक. एंड दिस इज कंटेनिंग द मल्टीपल क्रिस्टल्स ऑफ मेनी मेनी कलर्स. सो दिस इज एक्चुअली वॉट यू कॉल्ड एज द क्रिसमस ट्री कैटरेक्ट. दिस इज एक्चुअली द क्रिसमस ट्री कैटरेक्ट. क्रिसमस ट्री जैसा होता है. ओके, दिस इज एक्चुअली द क्रिसमस ट्री कैटरेक्ट. मल्टीपल क्रोमेटिक कलर्ड क्रिस्टल्स. एंड दिस इज नॉट फाउंड ऑन 25th of December. क्यों कहते हैं क्रिसमस ट्री कैटरेक्ट? बिकॉज ऑफ द मल्टीपल कलर्स. अगेन यू कैन गेट अ इंटीग्रेटेड क्वेश्चन बिकॉज इट इज फाउंड इन द मायोटोनिक डिस्ट्रोफी. तो रिमेंबर योर मेडिसिन. मेडिसिन में क्या होता है? वी आर हैविंग द फेशियल बैंडनेस, फ्रंटल बैंडनेस. वी आर हैविंग हैशेड फेशीज. हैशेड फेशीज का मतलब क्या होता है? बाइटेम्पोरल बोसिंग हो गया, फ्रंटल बैंडनेस हो गया, हार्ट कंडक्शन डिफेक्ट्स हो गए, कैटरेक्ट ऑल्सो. सो दिस इज क्रिसमस ट्री कैटरेक्ट. नाउ क्रिसमस ट्री कैटरेक्ट इज ऑल्सो पोस्टीरियर सब कैप्सुलर कैटरेक्ट. सो ऑब्वियसली इट विल बी विजुअल डिटोरेटिंग. यस, विजुअल डिटोरेटिंग भी होगा. वेरी गुड. सो इट विल बी दिस. नाउ वंस वी हैव डन ऑल टाइप्स ऑफ कैटरेक्ट, कमिंग टू द ट्रीटमेंट. ट्रीटमेंट बहुत सिंपल है. वी आर गोइंग टू डू द कैटरेक्ट सर्जरीज, ECCE विद द PCIOL implantation. So whenever we are doing the cataract surgery, we are going to do the ECC with the PCIOL implantation. PCIOL, PC here will be the posterior capsule. Posterior capsule is the best site. It is the best site for the IOL. Another important question, ECC means extracapsular. So extracapsular mein, that means you are not removing the capsule. Only then I can place the IOL over the posterior capsule because I am not removing. So ek bahut funny incident batati hu ki always we think ki ICCE mein we will have more complications in comparison to ECCE. So there was a question ki posterior capsular opacification PCO will be more common in. So uspe bhi students mark ki ICCE. Beta ICCE mein to we are actually removing the posterior capsule. So how can I have the opacification of the posterior capsule? So थोड़ा सा I know some anxiety होती है, numbness हो जाती है, लेकिन थोड़ा सा common sense भी लेके जाना है और वहां पर यूज करना है. ठीक है ना? नाउ सी दिस IOL. IOL के टू पार्ट्स हैं. यू कैन सी दिस ऑप्टिक्स एरिया एंड दी हैप्टिक्स एरिया. दैट्स अ ब्यूटीफुल क्रिसमस. यस, ब्यूटीफुल क्रिसमस ट्री. मतलब उसको देखते क्रिसमस वाली फील भी आ जाती है. तो वी हैव द ECCE विद द PCIOL इम्प्लांटेशन. वी आर प्लेसिंग द IOL ओवर द पोस्टीरियर कैप्स्यूल. दैट इज अ बेस्ट साइट. ठीक है? तो एक बार इंसिजन हम जल्दी से रिवाइज कर लेते हैं. ICCE में वी आर गिविंग 10 to 12 mm हो गया. ECCE ECC में 7 to 8 mm, देन SICS में 5 to 7 mm, एंड द किंग ऑफ कैटरेक्ट सर्जरी. किंग ऑफ कैटरेक्ट सर्जरी विल बी द फेको इमल्सिफिकेशन. द किंग ऑफ द कैटरेक्ट सर्जरी इज द फेको इमल्सिफिकेशन. इसमें कितना इंसिजन देते हैं? 3 to 3.5 mm, 3 to 3.5 mm, एंड दिस इज अ वेरी वेरी स्मॉल. तो क्योंकि वेरी वेरी स्मॉल है, देयर फोर इट इज एक्चुअली द सूचर लेस सर्जरी. तो इफ द क्वेश्चन कम्स विच इज द सूचर लेस सर्जरी, सूचर लेस सर्जरी इज द फेको इमल्सिफिकेशन. वेरी वेरी स्मॉल इंसिजन, तो ऑब्वियसली पूरा IOL नहीं जा सकता. आप क्या करें, फोल्ड करके ले जा सकते हैं, रोल करके ले जा सकते हैं. तो फोल्ड करके ले जा सकते हैं तो फोल्डेबल IOL हो गया, रोल करके ले जा सकते हैं तो रोलेबल IOL हो गया. तो फेको इमल्सिफिकेशन में वी आर यूजिंग द फोल्डेबल IOL, रोलेबल. आपकी लगेज में से सामान नहीं आता, हम क्या करते हैं, फोल्ड करके ले जाते हैं, रोल कर करके साइड में रख देते हैं. तो फोल्डेबल IOL, रोलेबल IOL हो गया. यस, एग्जाम वाला पिक विल लुक लाइक अ अशोका ट्री, हो सकता है, लेकिन बस ट्री जैसा लगे तो समझ जाना, ठीक है ना. सो दीज आर ऑल द टाइप्स ऑफ सर्जरीज. नाउ मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट कॉम्प्लिकेशन क्या है, जहां पर भी सर्जरी होती है इंडिया में वहां पर इंफेक्शन हो सकता है. और अगर इंफेक्शन हो जाए बेटा तो क्या हो सकता है, वी कैन हैव एक्सुडेट्स. एक्सुडेट्स मतलब पस. सो वी कैन हैव हाइपोपियन. एंड दिस पिक्चर ऑल्सो वी गॉट इन इनसेट नवम्बर 2022, जिसमें देयर वॉज अ फिश टेल इंजुरी. अब फिश टेल इंजुरी से भी पस हो सकता है, दैट वॉज अ फंगल कॉर्नियल अल्सर. कैटरेक्ट सर्जरी के इन्फेक्शन से भी वी कैन गेट अ पस, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज अ हाइपोपियन. तो योर डायग्नोसिस रिमेन्स द सेम. Here it is endophthalmitis due to which we are having hypopyon. वहां पर we were having corneal ulcer, but the picture will remain same, hypopyon and endophthalmitis. This is the worst thing, you know, most severe complication जो हो सकता है. And see, there is again a PYQ, late onset endophthalmitis is caused by. Late onset endophthalmitis किससे होता है? तो late onset endophthalmitis होता है by the propionibacterium acnes. And if they ask you the early onset, then this is caused by the staph epidermidis. This is caused by the staph epidermidis. The most important complication of the cataract surgery, जो सबसे बुरा हो सकता है for the patient as well as surgeon, is the endophthalmitis. End of ophthalmitis, मतलब end of eye है, you don't have the vision, and end of the career of the ophthalmologist also, because the patient does not have vision. तो end है, इसीलिए most severe complication है. You can remember it like this, ठीक है ना, याद रखोगे. Now ये देखो, ब्यूटिफुल डी शेप प्यूपिल. तो डी शेप प्यूपिल कहाँ मिलती है? अगेन अ PYQ. ये सारे PYQs हैं और मैं लिंक कर रही हूं इसे फनी इंसिडेंट से, सो दैट दे कैन क्लिक इन योर माइंड. जो फनी चीज होती है, रिलेट मतलब होती है, कुछ एक्सेप्शनल होती है, हटके होती है, वो चीजें हमको याद आ जाती हैं. तो उस तरह से हम इसको लिंक करके पढ़ते हैं. ओके, तो ये देखो, वी आर हैविंग द डिटैचमेंट ऑफ द आयरिस. तो जब डिटैचमेंट ऑफ द आयरिस होता है, उसको हम क्या बोल देते हैं? दिस इज कॉल्ड एज आयरिडोडायलिसिस. ब्यूटिफुल ऑडियंस, मतलब मेरे कहने से पहले ही डायग्नोसिस आ जा रही है, आयरिडोडायलिसिस है. आयरिडोडायलिसिस में वी आर हैविंग द डी शेप प्यूपिल. वी आर हैविंग द डी शेप प्यूपिल. सो दिस इज एक्चुअली आयरिडोडायलिसिस अलॉन्ग विद द डी शेप प्यूपिल. वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. अब ये देखो क्या दिख रहा है, दिस कैन बी आयरिस प्रोलैप्स. सो वी कैन ऑल्सो हैव द आयरिस प्रोलैप्स. प्रोलैप्स ऑफ द आयरिस भी हो सकता है. कब होगा? कोई धक्का कब मारेगा? जब ज्यादा प्रेशर लगाएगा. धक्का कब मार सकते हो? जब प्रेशर लगाओगे. तो कौन सा प्रेशर हो गया? IOP. तो वेन वी हैव द रेज्ड IOP, वी कैन हैव द आयरिस प्रोलैप्स. ठीक है, इसको ऐसे याद रखना है. ये देखो, इस बार ये आएगा बिकॉज लास्ट टाइम देर वॉज अ हाइपोपियन. तो इस बार जो क्वेश्चन आएगा 2023 में, वो ये आएगा. वट कैन यू सी हियर? यू कैन सी ब्लड. तो ये हो जाएगा ब्लड इन दी एंटीरियर चेम्बर. फेस्टून नहीं है बेटा, ये ब्लड है. ब्लड देख रहे हो, ब्लड है इन दी एंटीरियर चेम्बर. दिस इज कॉल्ड एज अ हाइफीमा. दिस इज कॉल्ड एज हाइफीमा. हाइफीमा क्या है? मोस्ट कॉमन अर्ली पोस्ट ऑपरेटिव कॉम्प्लिकेशन. मतलब आपने सर्जरी करी, अगले दिन पट्टी खोली, सबसे पहले क्या दिख सकता है? हाइफीमा. सबसे सीवियर क्या हो सकता है? एंडोफ्थेलमाइटिस. ठीक है ना, मोस्ट कॉमन अर्ली हो गया एंड मोस्ट सीवियर भी हो गया. अब लेट बाद में दोबारा आ गया, पेशेंट की सर्जरी हो गई, अगेन ही हैज कम विद डिमिनेशन ऑफ विजन. भाई अब क्या हो गया? अब PCO हो सकता है, पोसिया कैप्सुलर ओपेसिफिकेशन. हमने छोड़ दिया था पोसिया कैप्सूल, जो पोसिया कैप्सूल वी हैड लेफ्ट, नाउ इवन दैट कैन ओपेसिफाई. अब बच्चों को हमेशा एक कंफ्यूजन होता है कि अगर हम उसमें ओपनिंग दे देंगे, ठीक है, तो IOL गिर तो नहीं जाएगा बेटा, IOL नहीं गिरेगा। ये देखो, ये इसका ऑप्टिक्स पार्ट है, वी हैव द सेंट्रल ऑप्टिक्स पार्ट एंड हैप्टिक्स होंगे, हैप्टिक्स आर इन द पेरिफेरी। सो इफ आई एम गिविंग ओपनिंग इन द सेंटर, ठीक है ना, तो IOL विल नॉट फॉल एंड देर विल बी नो विट्रियस लॉस ऑल्सो। सो वी विल गिव जस्ट अ स्मॉल ओपनिंग इन द सेंटर, तो स्मॉल ओपनिंग इन द सेंटर आई कैन गिव विद द लेजर। कौन सा लेजर है, राइट इट इन द कॉमेंट सेक्शन। चलो बताओ जल्दी से, दैट which one we are going to use. So we are going to use a very very important laser. This is ND-YAG laser ho gaya. ND-YAG laser 1064 nanometer, full form of ND-YAG, wavelength of ND-YAG and unit of ND-YAG, mechanism of action of ND-YAG. Mechanism of action kya hota hai, it is photo disruption. मोटो इट इज द फोटो डिसरप्शन, मतलब इट इज क्रिएटिंग द ओपनिंग, फोटो डिसरप्शन है। वेवलेंथ एंड इट्स यूनिट इज अगेन वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। ये देखो, दिस इज एम्स 2017 है। ओके, डेली एक घंटे आया करो, ठीक है। आज देखो, ये देखो, तो वी आर हैविंग सो मेनी वैक्यूलेटेड सेल्स है यहाँ पे, छोटे छोटे जेल्स है, क्या जैसे पर्ल्स होते हैं, इसीलिए इनको क्या बोल देते हैं, एलशिंग्स पर्ल। देयरफॉर दिस इज कॉल्ड एज एलशिंग्स पर्ल। सो वी आर हैविंग, एक तो रिंग जैसी अपियरेंस थी, जिसमें रिंग जैसी अपियरेंस है, ये सोमरिंग रिंग के अट्रैक्ट है, और जहां पे छोटे छोटे पर्ल जैसे दिखते हैं। मैकेनिज्म ऑफ एक्शन फोटो डिस्क्रिप्शन है, वेरी करेक्ट है। मोटो क्या, फोटो मोटोरोला फोन होता है ये, फोटो डिसरप्शन है, ठीक है। देन वी हैव, जहां पे पर्ल्स ऐसे दिख रहे हैं, छोटे छोटे वैक्यूलेटेड पर्ल्स, उसको बोलते हैं एलशिंग्स पर्ल। दोनों का ट्रीटमेंट सेम है, बीच में ओपनिंग कर दो, ओपनिंग करके वहां से रेडिएशन चली जाएंगी, ठीक है ना, वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। अब लास्ट बट नॉट द लीस्ट, एक बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट, सुंदर सी पिक्चर दिखा रही हूं, ये देखो सुंदर सी पिक्चर है ये, दिस इज द लेंस, क्या देख रहे हो, वी आर हैविंग द प्रोट्रूजन ऑफ द लेंस, ठीक है ना, वी आर हैविंग द पोस्टीरियर प्रोट्रूजन। प्रोट्रूजन होता है तो क्या क्या देते हैं, कोनस कहते हैं, when this conical protrusion is in cornea, तो उसको क्या बोल रहे थे, केराटोकोनस। तो लेंस में होगा तो क्या बोल देंगे, लेंटिकोनस, ठीक है ना। आधी आधी ऑप्थेल्मोलॉजी तो आप मतलब ना इंग्लिश से समझ सकते हो, केराटो मतलब कॉर्निया, कोनस मतलब कोनिकल प्रोट्रूजन। सो कोनिकल प्रोट्रूजन इन द कॉर्निया है तो केराटोकोनस, कोनिकल प्रोट्रूजन लेंस में है तो लेंटिकोनस, ठीक है ना, वेरी क्लियर। कहां पे दिख रही है, पोस्टीरियर साइड पे दिख रही है ना, ये कॉर्निया है तो पोस्टीरियर साइड पे दिख रही है, तो पोस्टीरियर लेंटिकोनस। बहुत सिंपल है, एग्जामिनर को खुद इतनी ऑफ्था नहीं आती है, ठीक है ना। आप बहुत सिंपल सी बात मान के चलो, दैट यू नो मच मोर ऑफ्था देन द एग्जामिनर एट दैट टाइम, एंड यू कैन आंसर एनी डैम क्वेश्चन। जस्ट थोड़ा सा उस टाइम रिलैक्स होना है, रीड इट, सी द फोर ऑप्शंस, आंसर आपके सामने ही है, एंड सोच लो कि कौन बनेगा करोड़पति खेल रहे हो। द टू ऑप्शंस बहुत सिंपल होंगे टू रूल आउट, 50-50 लाइफ लाइन हमने ले ली, एंड यू आर लेफ्ट विद द टू ऑप्शन। अब उसमें से कोई एक तो आंसर है, तो देखो कि कौन सा रूल आउट हो पा रहा है, कौन सा रूल आउट हो पा रहा है, एंड यू आर लेफ्ट विद द राइट आंसर। घबराने का नहीं है, यू हैव रेड इट, यू हैव डन द हार्ड वर्क, आंसर आपके सामने है, यू विल आंसर इट करेक्टली, ठीक है ना। इंग्लिश भी वीक है तो वो भी चलेगा, इतनी इंग्लिश हम सब मेडिकोस को आती है जो हम काम चला ले, और बेटा उतनी ही काफी है, ठीक है ना, तो कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है, उतनी इंग्लिश हम सबको आती है। वंडरफुल। हाँ, तो एक और एक इम्पॉर्टेंट चीज, ठीक है ना, वैसे ये सिस्टमिक एसोसिएशंस है, और एक क्वेश्चन इसमें से हम रख सकते हैं, आएगा, ठीक है ना, इक्टोपिया लेंटिस पे, वी आर गोइंग टू टेक इक्टोपिया लेंटिस। तो जैसे इक्टोपिक प्रेगनेंसी होती है, वैसे ही इट इज इक्टोपिया लेंटिस। इक्टोपिक प्रेगनेंसी मतलब एबनॉर्मल पोजीशन ऑफ द फीटस, इक्टोपिया मतलब एबनॉर्मल पोजीशन, लेंटिस का मतलब लेंस। तो अब इतनी इंग्लिश तो हमें आ गई कि लेंटिस मतलब लेंस हो गया, इक्टोपिक का मतलब होता है एबनॉर्मल पोजीशन, तो हाँ जी, एबनॉर्मल पोजीशन ऑफ द लेंस। तो एबनॉर्मल पोजीशन ऑफ द लेंस कहां कहां मिलता है, कम ऑन। सो दिस इज अगेन यू आर गोइंग टू गेट इंटीग्रेटेड क्वेश्चन, ये पैथो और ऑफ्था के साथ आएगा। पेपर मैंने नहीं बनाया है, बट डेस्टिमेट बोल रही हूं, ठीक है ना। तो ऑफ्था प्लस पैथो का मानते हैं इसको, ऑफ्था प्लस पैथो, ऑफ्था प्लस पीडिया प्लस बायोकेमिस्ट्री हमने कर लिया है, ठीक है ना। एनडी यैग का फुल फॉर्म चलो बताओ एनीबडी एनीबडी एंटी या फुल फॉर्म राइट इन द कमेंट सेक्शन, दैट विल बी ऑफ हेल्प. तो एक्टोपिया एक्टोपिया लेंटिस में वी हैव द एबनॉर्मल पोजिशन. सो वन इज योर मार्फन सिंड्रोम, वी हैव द मार्फन सिंड्रोम. देन वी हैव द होमोसिस्टिनूरिया, वी आर गोइंग टू हैव द होमोसिस्टिनूरिया. देन वी आर हैविंग द एलर्ड एंड लॉस सिंड्रोम एंड देन वी हैव द व्हील मार्चेजनी सिंड्रोम इज ऑल्सो देयर. नाउ ऑल दीज क्वेश्चन विल कम एज द ऑफ्थ प्लस पैथो एंड ऑल्सो प्लस माइनस मेडिसिन यू आर ऑल्सो गोइंग टू गेट. बिकॉज मार्फन्स में वॉट यू आर गोइंग टू गेट, यू विल गेट द टॉल एंड थिन लिम्स. देन यू विल गेट वॉट, स्पाइडरी फिंगर्स जो लाइक दैट ऑफ अ मॉन्स्टर. यू आर गोइंग टू गेट वेरी टॉल एंड थिन विद द स्पाइडरी फिंगर्स एंड विद जीन डिफेक्ट, द फिब्रिलिन जीन. You are going to get fibrillin. So that is the patho, long thin limbs along with the spidery finger medicine, and they can ask you the ophtha, suprotemporal subluxation, or other way they can say that the patient is having suprotemporal subluxation with gene defect. They can ask you the type of heart defect. It is actually the aortic regurgitation, long and thin limbs with the spidery fingers with aortic regurgitation with the fibrillin gene defect. Then another one is the homocystinuria, just the opposite. Suprotemporal, opposite is infronasal. This is infronasal, similar signs with infronasal. Then which enzyme defect you can get also with the biochemistry. So all the actually subjects can be integrated with the ophthalmology. So you can see which enzyme defect we are giving, cystathione synthetase. So which vitamin you are going to give, B6. So many questions of previous INSET 2021. Very, very many, many questions. Yes. Ehlert and Law syndrome, mein, what you are going to get? So if you get the subluxation along with the blue sclera, another DD is the blue sclera also. And finally, we have Weill-Marchesny syndrome. Now, this is very, very amazing. This is also going to give you one integration. This will give you PEDS along with the ophtha. This is going to give you the PEDS along with the ophtha. Now, this will come as a question of a child along with a short stature. So this is actually a small child who is, you know, very golu molu bacha, because he is having short stature and also short and broad fingers. So ek bacha that is very, very short and very golu molu along with the brachydactyly. So if you are getting a child with the short stature, with the brachydactyly, along with the subluxation and along with the microspherophakia, then that is actually the Weill-Marchesny syndrome. So I hope, yes, always remember it as a golu molu bacha. All right, so coming to the next one. Yeah. So coming to the next one, this is your glaucoma. And as you remember, I always give you a blue baby boy, Bablu. Do you remember Bablu? Raise your hand. How many of you remember the Bablu? And we are going to talk about him. Always remember this Bablu. It is the blue baby boy and Bablu. Blue baby boy Bablu is there. So this blue baby boy Bablu, he will present with. So B for blue, and this blue is actually the blue sclera. Then it's a baby. It's more common in boys. Bablu, by which the question came in AIIMS. And also B for bilateral. It is also B for bilateral. And this Bablu will present with. So see the Bablu they had given. This was actually our VIBE image that came in AIIMS 2017. It came in AIIMS 2017. You can see that we are having the bilateral. Bablu is a boy, baby. You can see the blue sclera. It is the blue sclera that is there. And then this Bablu will always present with the BPL card. So always remember, whenever you see Bablu with the blue baby boy bilateral, it is actually B for Buphthalmos. So this Bablu will present with the B for the blepharospasm. B for blepharospasm, then we are going to have P for photophobia, and then L for the lacrimation. So always remember L for lacrimation. And this Bablu is also having two more things. You can see the hazy cornea. This is actually the hazy cornea. Now how will you get to see that this is hazy? You are not able to see the iris details. It is hazy. Now one more thing. Sometimes they will tell you in the question that it is megalocornea, but sometimes they will not. So how will you make out if you are not able to see this inferior white part? If I am not able to see the inferior limbus, that means it's a megalocornea. And take my words, this much is sufficient to say that this Bablu is having the Buphthalmos. So simple, we have got Bablu, we have got blue baby boy, along with the blue sclera, along with the BPL card. This baby will present with the BPL card. Below poverty line ke saath bachcha present karega. We have blepharospasm, we have photophobia, we have lacrimation, along with the hazy cornea, along with the megalocornea. Now Bablu is having something at from the butt, so obviously you cannot treat it with the drugs. Therefore, you have to do the surgery. So, treatment of choice is surgery. Now, another important thing, the type of stria. The type of stria that you get is the H for horizontal and H for half. Now, there was a question in Inset November 2022 also, that which of the following is false for the keratoconus. And keratoconus mein they had given you this half stria, while half stria are actually present where? The half stria are actually present in the Buphthalmos. So half stria is also important. Blue baby boy Bablu with the frosted glass appearance, with the megalocornea, with the half stria, do surgery. Now what surgery you have to do? So we have two things that we can do when we have got the clear cornea and when we have the hazy cornea. Clear cornea, hazy cornea. If we have a clear cornea, do the goniotomy. Now see, if the cornea is clear, I can see the angle. Just create an opening in that goniotomy. I cannot see the angle. Then do something at the trabecular meshwork. Then we do the trap plus trap. Then we do trap plus trap. So simple hai, try to see if they are asking you the question on the treatment. Try to find out the cornea is clear or the cornea is hazy and decide accordingly. Very, very important. Very, very important. You can see the direct question. Another thing now, another one is the primary open angle glaucoma. Primary open angle glaucoma. Now, primary open angle glaucoma ka, you can remember it as chronic simple glaucoma. Chronic hai, simple hai, glaucoma hai. Now, you have so many glaucomas, so how to remember the glaucomas from the words, ma'am? Yes, so I'll tell you how to remember this from the word itself. Primary means we have no known cause. भाई ऐसे ही तो हम करते हैं. Whenever in medicine we do not know the cause of anything, what we say कि it's primary, it's a essential hypertension or it's a primary hypertension. Patient भी डर जाता है कि अरे भाई क्या हो गया, we are having essential hypertension. But actually we know that we do not know the cause. So whenever we have primary, primary मतलब no known cause, open angle is equal to the trabecular blockade. So whenever we are having a trabecular blockade, it could be by anything, okay? It could be by anything. If I am having trabecular blockade, it is primary. Chronic, chronic means gradual diminution of vision. Simple means painless. And if I am saying it's a glaucoma, that means triad will be present. Now, I am telling you certain things which will help you in solving the questions just mathematically. Matlab, ophthalmology is equal to yes, ma'am, the most tough thing. Yes, because you have got so many glaucomas. So, I will tell you mathematical ophthalmology. Mathematical ophthalmology, that how to go about the questions. I have already told you that if you get a question on gradual, painless, progressive diminution of vision, just remember that your answer is either the cataract or it is primary open angle glaucoma. Number two, if you get the acute red eye, if you are getting the acute red eye means if you are having the sudden painful. If you are having the sudden painful diminution of vision, then either it is acute anterior uveitis or it is acute congestive glaucoma. Very, very simple you are going to have. Number three, if you are having the sudden painless, if we are having the sudden painless diminution of vision, that means something in the posterior segment. That means it is something related to the posterior segment. Number four, if you are having the floaters in the question, that means it's a vitreous pathology. If you are having the metamorphopsia in the question, write in the comment section what is metamorphopsia. That means it's a macular pathology. So just mathematically you can see, yes, it is gradual painless, that means cataract or open angle glaucoma. If it is acute red eye, acute anterior uveitis or acute congestive glaucoma, if it is sudden painless loss of vision, anything related to posterior segment, floaters means any vitreous pathology, that means vitreous disease. Metamorphopsia you will get in macular disease. Metamorphopsia means distorted vision, that means you are going to get the distortion of the vision. Right, distorted vision. So distorted vision means it is actually the metamorphopsia. Now whenever you have the triad, always remember what is a triad of the glaucoma. The triad of the glaucoma will consist of the raised intraocular pressure, we have the optic disc changes and the visual field effect. So if I have all the three, I can simply say it is actually glaucoma, or at least two out of three means glaucoma. So if I have only raised intraocular pressure, this is actually called as the ocular hypertension. And what is the drug of choice? Because somebody was saying that, tell me the drug of choice of everything. So drug of choice here will be actually the bitoxolol. Otherwise, when you look for the drug of choice for the primary open angle glaucoma, it is the prostaglandin analogs. But the drug of choice for the only the ocular hypertension is bitoxolol. But if I get the optic disc changes and if I get the visual field effects with the normal IOP, then this is called as normal tension glaucoma. Bitoxolol will be for the low tension glaucoma. So for the low tension glaucoma, we will have the bitoxolol. For the normal one, it will be the prostaglandin analogs. Alright. Now when I talk about the triad, very, very important. Jab bhi triad ki baat aati hai, you have to talk about the raised intraocular pressure. Write in the comment section what is the normal IOP. So how can I measure the IOP basically? Normal IOP is measured, it should be more than 21 mm of the mercury. This is measured by this Schiotz tonometer, Schiotz indentation. It is the Schiotz indentation tonometer. Now, what is the basic difference when I say indentation tonometer, applanation tonometer? Indentation matlab we are indenting the cornea. Exactly, it is 11 to 21 mm of the mercury. So when you have a weighing balance kind of a thing, we have this foot plate, we have a plunger, we have a pointer. This is your Schiotz tonometer. Direct question can come over this. Ye dekho, which procedure is being done? So this is again a PYQ. What kind of tonometer is this? So this is your indentation tonometer. And definitely one tonometer can be asked. See the other one. This question came in AIIMS 2017. As a image based question. What you can see is the probe. So this probe is going and it is causing flattening of cornea. So jo indent kar raha hai, that is indentation, and that is one which is just doing flattening of cornea. That is actually the एप्लेनेशन वन. नाउ एप्लेनेशन में देर आर सर्टेन थिंग्स दैट यू हैव टू रिमेम्बर. ये देखो कुछ इस तरह से होगा. दिस इज द प्रोब विच इज ऑफ द गोल्डमैन एप्लेनेशन टोनोमीटर. इट इज गोइंग एंड इट इज डूइंग फ्लैटनिंग ऑफ कॉर्निया. सो वॉट पार्ट इज कमिंग इन कॉन्टेक्ट? दिस वन. दिस इज सर्कल. इसीलिए वी आर गेटिंग दिस सर्कल ऑफ कॉन्टेक्ट. वाई? बिकॉज द प्रोब सर्कल इज कमिंग इन कॉन्टेक्ट एंड कॉर्निया इज ट्रांसपेरेंट. सो वी हैव टू स्टेन. विच स्टेन? फ्लोरोसीन स्टेन. देयरफॉर ग्रीन. एंड वॉट filter we use for fluorescein. It is actually the cobalt blue filter. So what is the principle? That is the most important part. That is called as the Imbert-Fick law. This is called as the Imbert-Fick law. Pressure is equal to force upon area. Simple hai. And area of the cornea cannot change. So area fix ho gaya. Because area cannot change. So pressure is directly proportional to force. Or pressure is equal to force into the constant. So if I want to find out the pressure, I have to take out the reading. Reading will be giving me force. And this constant is actually 10. So whatever reading I am getting multiplied by 10 and I will get the final value. Now see this question and answer it. All of the following are true about the above instrument except. Is it based on Imbert-Fick law? Yes. Is it a variable force? Yes. Because area was fixed. This is also true. 3.06 mm cornea is applanated. This is also true. So what is wrong? Cornea is stained with the rose bengal because you know that it is stained with the fluorescein stain. So even if you do not know the other three option, guys, have confidence. Even if you do not know the other options, but you know that the fluorescein stain is used, I can say answer is D because cornea is stained by rose bengal stain. They have given it. So even if you do not know all the options, then also you can do the MCQ correct. That is the beautiful aspect of the MCQ. So I think that's a very, very good thing. This is the final thing. When these mirrors are touching just inner edges of each other, there you have to take the reading. When they are touching just inner edges, there you have to take the reading. So this is the first part, that is the raised IOP. Now second is the optic disc changes. Optic disc changes mein, what is the final thing we are having is the cavernous kind of optic atrophy. Optic disc changes mein, we are going to have cupping. It will be, and guys, one more thing, normal CD ratio. No, so normal CD ratio mein ek bahut hi frequent baat hai. एक जगह लिखा होता है ना, वन ऑफ द वेरी कॉमन क्वेश्चन दैट सर्कुलेट्स की मैम दे हैव गिवन दैट नॉर्मल सीडी रेशियो इज अप टू 0.6. प्लीज, देर आर एक्सेप्शंस टू द कॉमन रूल्स बट द रूल्स आर नॉट मेड फ्रॉम द एक्सेप्शंस. नॉर्मल सीडी रेशियो इज 0.3 और 0.4 ओनली. Now, if I am saying that the person is having 0.6 but no any other change, then I have to say that 0.6 is normal here. But that does not mean that the normal CD ratio is 0.6. So, us question ko bother nahi karna hai. You have to remember that the normal CD ratio is 0.3 or 0.4. Okay? Very, very important. Normal CD ratio 0.3 or 0.4. And then the order of the visual field effects. The order of the visual field defects is also important. Let's write the order. And I had made a mnemonic for you in, that was the isopter contraction. First was the isopter contraction. Then we have got the bearing of the blind spot. Bearing of the blind spot. First important one was the paracentral. Paracentral will combine and form the Siddal scotoma, then is the Arcuate scotoma, which is also called as the Jerem scotoma, and next is the double Arcuate scotoma. Now, double Arcuate scotoma. Now, what was the mnemonic here? In corona. So, in corona, B and P should be doubly tested. It should be doubly tested. In corona, it should be actually doubly tested. Just a second. Yeah. So, this should be doubly tested. So, doubly hai isliye, two times ho jayega ye. Yes. So, in corona, isopter contraction, B for bearing of blind spot, P for paracentral scotoma, S for the Siddal scotoma, B for Jerem scotoma, then doubly is the double arcuate and tested. So, T for tunnel vision and T for temporal field is last to be affected. Another important question of NEET 2018, which field is last to get affected? The field which is last to get affected is the temporal field. Matlab, first the patient will become blind in the superior and inferior field, then he will become blind in the nasal field, and last to get affected will be the temporal field. So last tak jahan dikhta rahega, wo hai temporal field. Okay? Alright. So this is the one we are having. Now we come to the treatment. Ab treatment kaise karenge? We have got three things. we are having medical treatment, we are having the laser treatment and surgery. So sabse pehle we are going to give the medicines. Medicines mein prostaglandin analogs are there and beta blockers. They are actually making the what you called as the junk of the treatment. Ab kya hai that prostaglandin analogs have lot of side effects. They have become the drug of choice, but beta blockers are actually most commonly used because they are simple, having lesser side effects. If this is not working, then I go to the laser. This is actually the laser trabeculoplasty. Laser trabeculoplasty. Laser से हम क्या कर सकते हैं? We can burn the trabecular meshwork. वो देखा है जब चाय की छन्नी बहुत पुरानी हो जाती है. We have to burn it so that it starts draining the tea again. तो वही हम कर रहे हैं. We are making it warm and we are opening the trabecular spaces. This is the treatment of choice for the fellow eye. ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ चॉइस फॉर द फेलो आई एंड फाइनली क्या करेंगे फाइनली इज द सर्जरी सो व्हेन नथिंग इज देयर देन यू कैन डू द सर्जरी वेयर वी आर क्रिएटिंग अ फिस्टुला फिस्टुला वी आर क्रिएटिंग बिटवीन एंटीरियर चेम्बर एंड द सब कंजंक्टाइवल स्पेस दिस इज द लास्ट थिंग इफ इट इज नॉट ओपनिंग देन आई हैव टू क्रिएट आर्टिफिशियल ओपनिंग बिटवीन द एंटीरियर चेम्बर एंड द सब कंजंक्टाइवल स्पेस सो दैट द फ्लूइड कैन डायरेक्टली गो आउट इन टू द सब कंजंक्टाइवल स्पेस वॉट इज ए बी आर ए बी आर ए बी आर आई हैव नॉट रिटन ठीक है ना ऑल राइट नाउ कमिंग टू द एब्सोल्यूट एब्सोल्यूट इंपॉर्टेंट ये देखो जस्ट रिमेंबर दिस पिक्चर ऑफ अमिताभ बच्चन fiery red eye so this is actually lady amitabh bachchan I will say whenever you have a question on the eye of a lady amitabh bachchan similar to the acute red eye you are so we are having a female more than 50 years of age along with the acute red eye along with the raised intraocular pressure okay and along with the colored halos now another important thing is the colored halos another important thing is the colored halos now whenever we have colored halos in the question either it is cataract or it is acute congestive glaucoma or prostaglandins analogs ke baad kya tha it was a beta blockers and then third is the acute mucopurulent conjunctivitis so always remember it can be either of the three it can be cataract it can be acute congestive glaucoma or it is acute mucopurulent conjunctivitis so your life is simple lady amitabh bachchan fiery red appearance acute red eye a female more than 50 years of age can come with the nausea and vomiting with the colored halos that means it is a case of the acute congestive glaucoma you can see a mid dilated pupil now I told you that there are two things either it's a case of acute congestive glaucoma or it is a case of acute anterior uveitis okay acute congestive glaucoma or acute anterior uveitis uveitis will never have dilated pupil now how much blurry you may have the picture but if you are having a dilated pupil go towards glaucoma if you are having a meiotic pupil go towards uveitis moreover uveitis mein you will have keratic precipitates aqueous cell flare also so no confusion between acute congestive glaucoma and the acute anterior uveitis you can see this kind of a congestion you can see the circumcorneal congestion you can see the hazy cornea because of the sudden closure of the angle of anterior chamber there is also circumcorneal congestion in the acute anterior uveitis exactly you can have the circumcorneal congestion in the acute anterior uveitis as well as in acute congestive glaucoma but how can you differentiate because in uveitis you are going to have a meiotic pupil but in cases of glaucoma you will always have a mid dilated pupil so a typical clinical scenario you will have a acute red eye you will have a female more than 50 years of age raised intraocular pressure along with the colored halos along with a dilated pupil then you are sure that this is a case of acute congestive glaucoma this is not scleritis scleritis will not be associated with the hazy cornea it will not have raised intraocular pressure it will not have colored halos so that is why I am also telling you that whenever you have such kind of things first see the image, then see the options, and then read the question. Scleritis is very, very painful, usually associated with the connective tissue disorders like the rheumatoid arthritis also. Very, very important. So if a patient is having the acute congestive glaucoma, the main problem is the pupillary block. So basically we are having the pupil blocked, and therefore now the aqueous humor is collecting behind the iris. So iris was like this and it is getting now pushed by the aqueous humor. So aqueous humor is pushing the iris. When it is pushing, we are having this ballooning of the iris. So please write it in the comment section. What do you say? What do you say when there is pushing of iris? This is iris bombay formation. So if pupil is already blocked, kya kare? So we can create one more pupil. How can I create one more pupil? Give the opening in the iris. So therefore we can do laser iridotomy, or we can do the surgical PI. I can create this opening by the laser iridotomy. I can create the opening by the surgery, wedge shaped resection. So while the laser trabeculoplasty was done in cases of open angle glaucoma, in cases of angle closure glaucoma, we do the laser iridotomy or the surgical PI. Very, very important. Apart from this, how can you reduce the intraocular pressure? Now see, the drug of choice for the acute congestive glaucoma is actually a meiotic, that is pilocarpine, if I talk about the acute congestive glaucoma. But the first drug and the second drug to be used is not pilocarpine. The first drug to be used is the acetazolamide. It is the acetazolamide. Second drug to be used is actually the mannitol. Now why this is so? Why it is AMP? The first drug to be used is acetazolamide, second drug to be used is the mannitol, and then the drug of choice is actually pilocarpine. Cyclic AMP hota hai na, remember AMP. Because acetazolamide works on aqueous humor, mannitol works on vitreous humor. While the attack comes due to the mid dilatation of the pupil. So please remember the order AMP. First is acetazolamide, second is mannitol, and third is pilocarpine. This is for acute congestive glaucoma. While for open angle glaucoma, the drug of choice was prostaglandin analog. Another important thing, the treatment of choice for fallopian eye. When I talk about the treatment of choice for the fallopian eye, so for open angle glaucoma and for the angle closure glaucoma, open angle ke liye laser trabeculoplasty, angle closure ke liye laser iridotomy ya phir surgical PI. So whenever you have glaucoma, please remember it can be blue baby boy, bablu bhi ho sakta hai. It can be angry Amitabh Bachchan, female Amitabh Bachchan bhi ho sakti hai. It can be like the senile cataract, that is primary open angle glaucoma. So whether they are asking the drug of choice, treatment of choice, for main eye, or the treatment of choice for the other eye, please give the reading to the question. Very, very important. There are 10 seconds that you are spending in reading the question really matters. So that is not the waste of time. Very, very important. Okay. Now coming to the other types of acquired cataract. Now again a topic for 2023. Vertically oval pupil. Vertically oval pupil is this pupil that you can see here. Mid dilated vertically oval pupil. Slightly vertically oval. Okay? It is something like this. Now another important thing. See in the NEET, 2022, there was a question on this. There was an image Boyer's question where you can see the dandruff like material. Here you can see the dandruff like material in the trabecular meshwork, which was blocking the trabecular meshwork. Trabecular blockade matlab open angle glaucoma by the dandruff material. That means you know the reason. So it's a secondary open angle glaucoma. Therefore it's a secondary open angle. Whenever we have a trabecular blockade, it's a open angle, known cause secondary, no known cause primary. Theek hai? So this is a pseudo exfoliative glaucoma, and what is important for 2023 is this. You can see pigments on the cornea. So these pigments are causing the trabecular blockade. This is actually the Krukenberg spindle. So I told you in the cataract also that the Krukenberg spindles are important. They are the actually pigments which are blocking the trabecular meshwork. Very, very important. This is also secondary open angle glaucoma, Krukenberg spindles, pigments on the posterior surface. See, this is the question. You can see this is the NEET 2022 question, image based question, pseudo exfoliation glaucoma. Yes, what striate you will see in acute congestive glaucoma? Can you answer this question? Then see this. Here you can see the neovascularization over the iris. You can see neovascularization over the iris. So this is rubeosus iridis. So if I have lot of vascularization over the iris, this can actually close the iris. Adhesions, because we can have fibrovascularization. So angle close. Therefore, this is secondary angle closure glaucoma, neovascularization. Now, whenever we have neovascularization, means I will have hypoxia. Hypoxia means the proliferative diabetic retinopathy. Therefore, the most common cause will be proliferative type of diabetic retinopathy. The lot of VEGF that will be released that will cause neovascularization, and another important is the CRVO. CRVO will cause the 100 day glaucoma. This will cause 100 day glaucoma. Another question of NEET PG 2018. So all the questions of the cataract and glaucoma, secondary glaucoma, they are done. Can you see this? We can have the circumcorneal congestion both in cases of uveitis as well as the glaucoma. But as you can see, the acute congestive glaucoma is much, much more fiery in comparison to the uveitis. Along with the colored halos, with the nausea, vomiting, with the raised intraocular pressure, and nobody told me the triad. What triad you are going to get? You will also get the Vogt's triad. PDF में इतना शॉर्ट फॉर्म नहीं मिलेगा. यू विल गेट ऑल फुल फॉर्म्स इन द PDF. ठीक है, यू आर गोइंग टू गेट स्प्लैश टोमेटो फंडस नहीं है, Vogt's triad. यू आर गोइंग टू गेट द Vogt's triad इन केसेस ऑफ अक्यूट कंजेस्टिव ग्लोकोमा. व्हाट आर द पार्ट्स? यू हैव द ग्लोकोमा फ्लेकन्स, वी हैव पैचेस ऑफ आयरिस एट्रोफी, एंड देन थर्ड विल बी द पिगमेंट्स ऑन द पोस्टीरियर सर्फेस ऑफ द कॉर्निया. दैट विल बी द Vogt's triad. एग्जैक्टली. So now coming to all the fundus images, I think fundus ride is a must, and we will quickly try to identify all the images of the retina, because you know, once you make the diagnosis, you are able to recognize. I think the diagnosis and the treatment are not difficult then. So because we have to start with the normal first. Before going to the abnormal, first see the normal fundus. This is the normal fundus. You can see this is normal. Just a second. I think it has gone blurred. Yeah. So this is actually the normal fundus. Now it's coming fine. Normal fundus mein you can see a reddish glow. Why we are getting this reddish glow? Red glow is actually due to the choriocapillaries. This reddish glow is found due to the choriocapillaries. They are shining behind the retina. And when you look at the central retina, we are going to have this optic disc and the macula. Now, what is important is the diameters. Optic disc is 1.5 mm while the macula is 5.5 mm. And if you look at the distance between the two, it is the two disc diameter. Now, how much is one optic disc? It is 1.5. So, it is 2 into 1.5. This will give me 3 mm. This is the distance between the two. Now, distance kyun important hai? In order to see in the fundus that this lesion is near the macula or not. So, just see ki the center of the macula and the optic disc, uske beech mein you are having two optic discs. So, I should be able to manage two optic discs in this. So, by this you can easily find out that it is coming in the vicinity of the macula or not. Okay, that is the main purpose. Now coming to the anatomy of the retina, physiology of the retina, and the histology of the retina. So first we start with the basic structure of a rod and a cone. Whenever I talk about the central retina, which cells we have the rods and the cones. So rod and cone may we have a outer segment and inner segment. Then we have this external limiting membrane. Then is this is the nucleus and then this is the synaptic body. Now outer segment and inner segment is actually present in the layer of the rods and cones. Now take my words, there are will be at least 2 to 3 questions from these areas. One, you will are going to get question on cherry red spot, one you are going to get on the fundus image, and one on the investigation also. So this outer segment and inner segment you are going to get in the layer of rods and cones. Next ho gaya external limiting membrane, nucleus. Nucleus will be in the outer nuclear layer and the synaptic body will be in the outer plexiform layer. I know histology is a nightmare, but I am promising you that after this session it will be a piece of cakewalk and you will wish that this question should come in the exam so that you can make it correct. This is my promise to you. So whenever you see the histology, ye dekho. So anatomy of the retina, dekhte hain. How will you see it? You are going to get something of this sort of section in the examination, something like this. Obviously, you will not be given the labeling and they will ask you that which layer of the retina is this. So out of these layers, they will give you any 4 layers. They are going to ask you 1, then 2, then this is 3 and this is 4. So they are going to ask you what are the names out of these 4 layers. Now in fractions of the seconds, you can find out is it a nuclear layer? These 2 will be the nuclear layer, or is it a plexiform layer? So this will be a plexiform layer, this will be the plexiform layer, and this will be the nuclear layer, and this is also a nuclear layer. So within fractions of the seconds, just by seeing, I can tell that is it a nuclear layer, plexiform layer, nuclear layer, or plexiform layer. Now can you see this? The darkly pigmented one is the nuclei and uske beech mein is the plexiform layer. Now the only thing that you need to know it, is it the outer side or is it the inner side? Toh kaise pata chalega? For finding out the outer side, for outer side, now outer means outer nuclear layer. So what is present outside the outer nuclear layer? There are 3 things. So you may see any of the 3. Start from the choroid. If you are able to see the lumen of the vessel, so you will be able to see the lumen of the vessel, something like this. Number 2, what you can see is the RPE layer. RPE layer mein we will get the darkly pigmented layer. So because it contains the melanin pigment, it will contain something like this. And then 3rd will be the outer segment and the inner segment. These are the 3 things with the help of which you are able to identify which is this one. Now see this, the choriocapillary. So you can see this is actually number 1. This is the lumen of the vessels. You are able to see the lumen of the vessels. Then number 2, you can see the cut section. The cut section, this RPE layer. This is the darkly pigmented RPE layer. And you will be able to see only the lines here. These lines are actually the outer segment and the inner segment. Now believe guys, in the paper, that section that will be present, you won't be able to see anything apart from these lines in the outer segment and inner segment. Then RPE layer, darkly pigmented, you are easily, you are able to identify. But the guarantee is not there that they will show you. Because what happened in AIIMS 2015, from where they started actually, 2015 mein they had given the section from here. So you were able to see the choriocapillaries, you were able to see this RPE layer, and you were able to see this layer of rods and cones also. In 2016 they gave the section from here, but still you could see the RPE. But in the 2017 they had given the section from here, and now you could see only the outer segment and the inner segment. And if they give the section from here, you can never know that is it the outer side or the inner side. And that is why they have not repeated the question after 2017. So whenever you are having, something of this sort, just see whether there are choriocapillaries, whether there is RPE layer, or whether there is outer segment and inner segment. So let us try to do it with the help of a question, guys. Can you see? They are asking which layer is this? So let us do it. let us do it. You can see that there are two layers of darkly pigmented. This one is also there and this is also there, darkly pigmented. And therefore, this is a nuclear layer and this is a nuclear layer. Then you have got this one. This is a plexiform layer and this is a plexiform layer. Now, guys, can you see? Can you tell me, is it the outer side or the inner side? Quickly, quickly, can you tell me? Is it the outer side or is it the inner side? Exactly. So it is the inner side because you can see this is the choroid here. Then you can see this is the RPE layer, darkly pigmented. And then you can see this will be your, okay, I have written here. And then you can see this is your plexiform layer. So this is your outer segment and inner segment. Therefore, I can say this is your outer nuclear, outer plexiform, inner nuclear and inner plexiform layer. And I can say, therefore, this is the inner plexiform layer. Similarly, we can do one more question, guys, because I think that this question can come. The chances of getting repeated one question after 5 years are very, very high. And this question came in 2017. Therefore, I can expect this question this time. Again, you can see that this is a nuclear layer and this is a nuclear layer. Therefore, this is a plexiform layer and this is also a plexiform layer. Now, can you tell me, is it the outer side or is it the inner side? So, can you see this? This is actually outer segment and inner segment, just lines. So, this is outer nuclear, outer plexiform, inner nuclear and inner plexiform. Therefore, the answer will be the outer plexiform layer. Therefore, it is outer plexiform layer. You can see this. Okay, so I think this question will go right. You know the anatomy of the retinal layers. Which layer is this? You will be able to do it very, very quickly. Okay, now you know. And now comes the physiology of the retinal layers. See, you don't have to even cram the order of the layers which are present in the retina. You start from the RPE layer. Retinal pigment epithelium. Pigment means which pigment? Melanin pigment. Darkly pigmented melanin pigment. Then we have the layer of rods and cones. Now, how to remember rods and cones? Because rods and cones are photoreceptors. So, obviously, they will be present on outer side. So, after the RPE layer, I have the layer of the rods and cones. And you have already read that the layer of rods and cones only contains the outer segment, inner segment. And then we have external limiting membrane. Now, uske baad se, we have nuclear, plexiform that will go on. So, kya hai? So, we will start from the nuclear. And obviously, we always start with the first line. Jab banate, toh hamesha first se banate. Therefore, first I will have nuclei of first order. And first order are now the rods and cones. Always remember that after an update, now it is there that we will have the rods and cones as a first order neurons. And I know there has been a lot of controversy about the first order neurons, but take my word, as far as ophthalmology is concerned, rods and cones are the first order neurons. So we start from the nuclei of first order, then we have inner nuclear layer, that means nuclei of second order. So beech mein kya ho jayega? Synapse. So we have the nuclei of first order, then we have synapse between first and second. Nuclei of second order, that means bipolar cells. Then we have synapse between second and third. Third is ganglionic cells. Isiliye next is the ganglionic cell layer. Ganglionic cell layer will go into nerve fiber layer. Nerve fiber layer will form the optic nerve. And finally, internal limiting membrane. Finally, internal limiting membrane. So order is also very, very easy. You don't have to cram the names of the layers. Just go with the first order, rods and cones, synapse between first and second. Then go with the second order, bipolar cells, synapse between second and third, that is ganglionic cells, then ganglionic cell layer, nerve fiber layer and the internal limiting membrane. So histology, the physiology and the ophthalmology of the retinal layers are very, very clear. I hope you have understood this. Now let's start with the fundus ride and keep on commenting yourself also. Let's see. Ma'am had dinner. Dinner toh aaj main hafta ke baad hi karungi. And यू पीपल ऑल्सो डू द डिनर आफ्टर द ऑप्थल्मोलॉजी. हिलना नहीं है जब तक कि हम ऑफ्ता पूरी नहीं करते. लेट्स हैव अ फंडस राइड टुगेदर हियर गाइज. यू कैन सी कीप ऑन कॉमेंटिंग योर सेल्फ ऑल्सो. लेट्स सी हाउ मच यू रिमेम्बर. दिस इज एक्चुअली द रॉड स्पॉट. You can see the rod spot here, and rod spot is found in the subacute bacterial endocarditis. And this is a question of NEET 2018. And if you have done the questions of PYQs, I think you will realize that we are doing all the PYQs right here, all the PYQs of ophthalmology. Then you can see the vitreous hemorrhage. We can see the blood in the vitreous cavity. And what did I told you that whenever we have the vitreous pathology, what can I have? Vitreous mein we will have the floaters. Very good. Very good. So vitreous mein we are going to have floaters. Aur kya bataya tha? What when we have in the posterior segment? Posterior segment mein means sudden painless. So there comes your two important clinical features. We will have sudden painless diminution of vision also, and you will have floaters also. Floaters because of vitreous pathology, posterior segment ke wajah se sudden painless diminution of vision. Very, very important. Ye bata do. $100 million question. What is this? You are going to get this question in 2023. Most important DDA. What is this? This is actually the cherry red spot, and you can see pale retina. The retina is crying because only one spot is red. Therefore, it is the cherry red spot. Now let us start with the DD. Who will tell the DD, guys? DD बता दो, because this is going to come. ये आ ही रहा है 2023 में. We are having the cherry trees never grows tall in mud and sand. ठीक है. Cherry trees do not grow tall in mud and sand. So we are having the CRAO, Tay-Sachs disease, Niemann-Pick disease. We are having anglioidosis, T for trauma, and M for metachromatic leukodystrophy, and S for send-off disease. Very good. I think सबने सही सही लिखा है. Very good है. ये देखो, this is a question that came in NEET 2022. A patient comes with mental retardation, और एक और था, patient was bedridden also. Patient is bedridden, mental retardation in the cherry red spot. Answers please. Can I have the answers please? So question number 10 का, patient is coming with a mental retardation, bedridden, a cherry red spot है, again ophtha with the integrated one. You are getting the mental retardation, bedridden, a cherry red spot है, medicine के साथ, it is integrated. This is the Tay-Sachs disease. So you are going to get a question on the cherry red spot. Then the most beautiful, जिसकी कोई बात भी कर रहा था, most beautiful fundus. This is the best fundus appearance. Valentine week hai. So it is giving you the reddish appearance. So many roses inside the fundus. When you are having so many roses inside the fundus, so many hemorrhages. What is this actually? It is the splashed tomato appearance. Splashed tomato appearance. Bacche sauce gira gaye. So whenever there is lot of sauce or ketchup sauce appearance, or somebody has squeezed the tomato inside the fundus, this is the splash tomato appearance. Where do you get it? CRVO. Very good. It is the CRVO. So we can have CRVO with the cherry red spot, splash tomato appearance, CRVO. Agar fundus pehchan loge, so you will know. Both will be found in males more than 50 years of age with the slightly same risk factors, but isme hypertension and smoking are very, very important. So if you are having a male more than 50 years of age with the splash tomato appearance, with the 100 day glaucoma, with the hypertension and smoking, CRVO. Ye dekho na, NEET 2018 question hai, 100 day glaucoma, all the questions. Ye dekho, and I think if you have read in the class, my class, you know what is this tidy fundus cheat code. Come on, tidy fundus is the cheat code of. Let's get started. Kya hai tidy fundus? Kahan milta hai? You can see these two things. We are having the flame shaped hemorrhages and these large spots. Large spots kya hai? These are the soft exudates. So if you are having the flame shaped hemorrhages along with the soft exudates, along with the nasal angiospasm, along with the nasal angiospasm. So if you are getting very neat and tidy fundus, that means hypertension. Kyun hypertension? Because you are getting spasm. Spasm means thinning of vessels. So because vessels have become thin, so you know fundus has become clear. Don't quote it anywhere. This is just for your cheat code. If you get very very neat and tidy fundus, this is actually hypertension, retinopathy, flame shaped hemorrhages, and the soft exudates both are present in the nerve fiber layer. So we have flame shaped hemorrhages, we have soft exudates present in the nerve fiber layer. The first is the nasal angiospasm and petho portion. Petho, what is the normal AV ratio? Normal AV ratio kya hota hai? A or V kya hota hai? A is the artery, V is the vein. So again, the histopathology, yeah. So which is wider, artery is wider or vein is a wider? It is actually vein which is wider. So normal ho gaya 2:3, normal is 2:3. So when we are having thinning of the artery, what we are going to get? Therefore here you will get 1:3. So again, hypertension retinopathy is the ophtha plus petho, ophtha plus histology, ophtha plus medicine, all these things. 2:3 se kya ho jayega? 1:3, very very simple. ठीक है, देन कमिंग टू डी फॉर डायबिटीज एंड डी फॉर डर्टी फंडस. कम ऑन, डर्टी फंडस सबको पता है, मैंने सबको पढ़ाया व्हाट इज डर्टी फंडस एंड वेयर डू यू गेट इट. डी फॉर डायबिटीज एंड डी फॉर डर्टी फंडस, वी आर गोइंग टू गेट द डर्टी फंडस इन द डायबिटीज. डी फॉर डर्टी फंडस, डी फॉर डायबिटीज ऑल्सो, ठीक है ना. सो यहाँ पे हमें क्या मिल रहा है? वेरी वेरी स्मॉल वी आर गेटिंग माइक्रो ऑनरिजम्स, देन वी आर गेटिंग द डॉट्स एंड वी आर गेटिंग द ब्लॉट्स ऑल्सो. डी फॉर डायबिटीज, डी फॉर डॉट्स, डी फॉर डीपर हेमरेजेस. वी आर ऑल्सो गेटिंग डी फॉर डीपर हेमरेजेस अलॉन्ग विद डी फॉर डायबिटीज, डी फॉर डर्टी फंडस, डी फॉर डॉट्स, डी फॉर डीपर हेमरेजेस अलॉन्ग विद वेरी वेरी स्मॉल एक्सुडेट्स कॉल्ड एज हार्ड एक्सुडेट्स. हार्ड में भी डी आता है, hard also contains D. So we are having soft. Soft mein there is no D. So it is found in hypertension. Hard mein D aa raha hai, deeper hemorrhages hai. Then we are having dots and blots and dirty fundus. This is actually the NPDR. This is actually the NPDR stage. Now layers kaise yaad rakhoge? Do you remember the opal? Which layers of the retina always show the pathologies? It is actually opal. Always remember the open, it opens the gate for retinal diseases. It opens the gate for retinal diseases. Outer plexiform, inner nuclear hai. So outer plexiform layer and the inner nuclear layer, these two layers opens the gate for the retinal diseases. So out of these, hard exudates are present in outer plexiform. Remember it as HOP. रिमेंबर इट एज अ हॉप. आउटर प्लेक्सीफॉर्म में हार्ड एक्सुडेट्स हो गया, तो बाकी दोनों किसमें मिलेंगे? इनर न्यूक्लियर लेयर कंटेन्स द माइक्रो एन्यूरिज्म्स एज वेल एज द डीपर हेमरेजेस, एज वेल एज द डीपर हेमरेजेस. आउटर प्लेक्सीफॉर्म लेयर ओपन्स इज ओपनिंग द गेट्स, एग्जैक्टली. सो रिमेंबर द निमोनिक हॉप, हार्ड एक्सुडेट्स इन द आउटर प्लेक्सीफॉर्म, सो अदर टू थिंग्स विल बी प्रेजेंट इन द इनर न्यूक्लियर लेयर. सो इफ यू आर हैविंग ऑल द चेंजेस ऑफ डायबिटीज बट देर इज नो न्यू वैस्कुलराइजेशन, then it is NPDR. If you are having the changes of diabetes plus neovascularization, then it is PDR. So PDR mein kya hai? Lot of proliferation. Proliferation matlab lot of neovascularization. So let us see the neovascularization. See this beautiful lacy pattern. So much of neovascularization you are having. Ye dekho, you are having neovascularization. This is optic disc. So this will be NVD. And you are having elsewhere also NVE. Just looking at this, you can see that this is neovascularization. Neovascularization matlab PDR, lot of hemorrhages because new blood vessels will always bleed. Now another important question. एक और चीज देखो, हाउ कैन यू डिफरेंशिएट बिटवीन हार्ड एक्सुडेट्स एंड द सॉफ्ट एक्सुडेट्स. हाउ कैन यू डिफरेंशिएट बिटवीन हार्ड एक्सुडेट्स एंड सॉफ्ट एक्सुडेट्स? नीट पीजी 2021, वेन यू सी द लार्ज वन, फ्लफी जो है, सॉफ्ट कॉटन बॉल जैसे हैं, जो कॉटन बॉल जैसे हैं, लार्ज फ्लफी है, दे आर द सॉफ्ट एक्सुडेट्स. जो छोटे हैं, कॉन्क्रीट जैसे हैं, दे आर एक्चुअली द हार्ड एक्सुडेट्स. So can you see this classroom picture actually came in NEET 2021 and they not only asked you fundus image, they also asked you sign. The answer was hard exudates in the diabetic retinopathy. And again, diabetic retinopathy is 2023. You are going to get a question on cherry red spot as well as diabetic fundus. Matlab, you know, 200 questions will come in an exam, and I can guarantee that at least in 20 questions out of 200, diabetes will be there as a risk factor. Iska matlab 10% of the questions will be on diabetes, and therefore all the complications of the diabetes are going to be asked. Diabetic foot, diabetic nephropathy, diabetic ulcers, as well as diabetic retinopathy. So be prepared for the diabetes, be prepared for the cherry red spot. You are going to get this. So we are having tidy fundus, dirty fundus ho gaya, NPDR and PDR. NPDR and PDR bhi ho gaya. And then coming to the PRP. Now this is the most important thing that you are going to give the diabetes. This is your 2022. What they asked last year was that what is the treatment that you are giving for neovascularization and for the so many deposits. So because you are having so many hemorrhages, lot of neovascularization, we have to seal those vessels. So what can you do is the pan-retinal photocoagulation. That is your PRP. India is diabetogenic capital. India mein toh yes, jase we are getting developed, we are getting more hypertension and more diabetes. We are getting rich, and therefore Richmond disease are getting more. Jitne zyada rich honge, utna zyada stress aega, utna zyada hypertension aur utna zyada diabetes. So you know, ye sare signs of prosperity hain. All these are signs of prosperity. So hypertension and diabetes, CRAO, CRBO, we have done. ठीक है? Now another important thing is the retinitis pigmentosa. Simple, you have to see the triad for the retinitis pigmentosa. If you see the triad, you are sure that this is a case of RP. Even if you have not seen the patient, I can guarantee yes. So what you are able to see, so three things: the triad of RP, you can see the pale and waxy optic disc, you can see the pigmentary spicules, and number three, you are able to see the arteriolar attenuation. Now this is actually common in boys. That is utna zyada PYQ. exactly, jitna zyada padega utna zyada PYQs aayenge. Exactly. So we are having boys mein more common hai, bilateral bhi hai. So we are having the pale and waxy optic disc ho gaya, pigmentary spicules ho gaya, arteriolar attenuation in a boy, and a bilateral retinitis pigmentosa. Now retinitis pigmentosa along with this other things again means a integrated question. So you can get this question with the ophtha plus medicine, ophtha plus pediatrics also. See number one kya hoga. Number one is a Lawrence-Mayen-Beadle syndrome. This is a very important question. A child is coming with hypogonadism, child is coming with the obesity, child is coming with the polydactyly, with the night blindness. Night blindness is the most important thing and the earliest thing that you are getting in the retinitis pigmentosa. Why? Because rods are affected earlier than the cones. So if rods are affected, rods matlab R for R se yaad rakhna hai, rods matlab raat. Raat mein dekhne mein help karte hai. They are actually rods, and isiliye when rods are affected, we are going to have the night blindness. Night blindness ka agar bachcha aata hai bilateral, bachcha bhi B se hai, boy hai, bilateral hai, with the triad hai, ye bachche ko retinitis pigmentosa hai. And once you know it is retinitis pigmentosa, look for the other features. So very very typical Lawrence-Mayen-Beadle syndrome, we can have Pokinus syndrome, then we can have the Rifson syndrome, Usher syndrome, and the Holgren syndrome. So all the things are there, but you need not remember each and everything. Just remember that one of the things always constant hai, retinitis pigmentosa. If you remember these syndromes from other subjects, it is very good. One or two things you can remember. ठीक है ना? जैसे कि ये वाला है. This is very important. अब ये देखो, again ophtha plus patho. So one important thing is that when you are reading the ophthalmology, you are revising all the subjects. You are revising ophtha, patho, anatomy, biochemistry, diabetes, hypertension, medicine also. So there are so many things. So you have already done the patho session. So I know you know what are these cells. These are actually the Spur cells. So if you are getting the Spur cells, acanthocytes, along with the retinitis pigmentosa, if I am getting Spur cells along with the retinitis pigmentosa, then this is actually the Basson-Coswig. Then it is the Basson-Coswig syndrome. Very, very important. ए बीटा लाइपोप्रोटीनिया नीमिया, एक्सीलेंट गाइज, एक्सीलेंट, हाउस एमडी वेरी गुड है। तो ए बीटा लाइपोप्रोटीनिमिया, पवित्रा इज ऑल्सो करेक्ट। तो स्पर सेल्स है विद आरपी है ए बीटा लाइपोप्रोटीनिमिया विच इज अ पार्ट ऑफ द बेसन कॉन्विक सिंड्रोम। बस स्पेलिंग थोड़ी सी गलत है लेकिन चलेगा क्योंकि आपको लिखना नहीं है, ठीक है ना। देखो नाउ अनदर टिपिकल बुल्स आई मैक्यूलोपैथी, ये गेम सब खेलते हैं बुल्स आई मैक्यूलोपैथी। सो यू विल गेट अ बुल्स लाइक लीजन, बुल्स आई हम लोग बहुत सारी एक्टिविटीज करते हैं। ये देखो सो वी हैव अ हाइपर पिगमेंटेड एरिया, हाइपो पिगमेंटेड एंड उसके बाद फिर से हाइपर पिगमेंटेड एरिया वी आर गोइंग टू गेट। दिस इज कॉल्ड एज बुल्स आई मैक्यूलोपैथी। वेन एवर यू गेट बुल्स आई मैक्यूलोपैथी दिस इज एक्चुअली अ क्वेश्चन ऑफ ऑफ्था प्लस फार्मा। ये देखो फार्मा भी आ गया। दिस इज ड्यू टू द टॉक्सिसिटी ऑफ क्लोरोक्विन और द हाइड्रोक्सो क्लोरोक्विन टॉक्सिसिटी। इफ यू आर गेटिंग अ क्वेश्चन ऑन द टॉक्सिसिटी ऑफ क्लोरोक्विन और हाइड्रोक्सी क्लोरोक्विन बुल्स आई मैक्यूलोपैथी, बट यू हैव टू सी दैट दिस टॉक्सिसिटी अकर आफ्टर 5 years। सो इफ अ पेशेंट इज टेकिंग क्लोरोक्विन और हाइड्रोक्सी क्लोरोक्विन इन द टॉक्सिक डोसेज फॉर 5 years वी कैन हैव बुल्स आई मैक्यूलोपैथी। नाउ हू विल टेल द टेस्ट, सबसे ज्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट पीजीआई 2020, पीजीआई 2020 क्वेश्चन, व्हाट आर द टेस्ट विच आई यूज फॉर द स्क्रीनिंग। Yes, it's a irreversible lesion. Very good. It's a irreversible lesion. And what are the tests given by American Academy of Ophthalmology? The tests which are given by the American Academy of Ophthalmology for this. So there are 5 tests. Number 1 is the visual acuity and the fundus. Visual acuity and the fundus we are going to do. Number 2 is the HFA field we are going to do. Multifocal. Multifocal ERG we are going to do. Number 4, spectral OCT. Spectral OCT we are going to do. And number 5 is the autofluorescence. Autofluorescence. Now, how many of you know the meaning of autofluorescence? Some lesions are autofluorescent. They do not need the dye, but the lesion will fluoresce. Ye dekho. This is actually autofluorescence. So this lesion is autofluorescent. Like we have drusens. Drusens are also autofluorescent. While sometimes I have to use a fluorescent dye in order to make that lesion fluoresce. So these are autofluorescent while some lesions are not autofluorescent. Multifocal ERG. Bull's eye maculopathy, chloroquine, hydroxychloroquine toxicity, 5 years irreversible lesion and the test. And the tests which are done for the screening, very very important. Theek hai? This is there. फिर ये देखो वेरी वेरी ब्यूटिफुल, वॉट इज दिस गाइज, कैन यू सी, दिस इज एक्चुअली द एग योग अपियरेंस, दिस इज द एग योग अपियरेंस। एग योग अपियरेंस इज फाउंड इन द बेस्ट डिजीज, इट इज फाउंड इन द बेस्ट डिजीज। एंड वॉट इज द बेस्ट टेस्ट फॉर द बेस्ट डिजीज, वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, पीवाईक्यू मतलब मोस्ट पॉपुलर है ये। वॉट इज द इन्वेस्टिगेशन ऑफ चॉइस, इट इज द ईओजी। बेस्ट टेस्ट फॉर द बेस्ट डिजीज इज एक्चुअली द ईओजी। और ये क्या है, this is the very very typical, this is the beaten bronze appearance, this is actually the beaten bronze appearance. Beaten bronze appearance is found in cases of the Stargardt disease. This is found in cases of Stargardt disease. Now what is the investigation of choice here? Investigation of choice in the best disease was the EOG, while the investigation of choice here is actually FFA. Ye dekho. Another important question, the investigation of choice par bhi a question aa sakta hai because there are so many tests that you are doing in cases of retina. It is actually the FFA. And what is the sign that you get? This is called as dark choroid or the silent choroid. And this question came in actually AIIMS 2017. You are going to get the dark choroid or the silent choroid. Theek hai na? Do macular dystrophy is very very important. You can see, then see this. This is actually metamorphopsia. You can see the distortion of the forest. Movies mein hamesha aisa hi dikhate hai na, aisa ghoomta hua. That is actually metamorphopsia. See, again mathematical ophtha. There can be diminution of vision, there can be loss of vision, there can be blurred vision. There can be blurred vision, there can be distorted vision, there can be distorted vision. These are all different. These are all different. Diminution of vision. Diminution of vision means either I'm going to have cataract or glaucoma. Cataract or glaucoma. Loss of vision, retinal detachment. Or we can have the CRAO, CRVO. So you are going to have this. Theek hai? Blurring of vision, corneal edema. Blurring of vision, corneal edema. Distorted matlab macular disease. So Actually, you know, OFTA is very, very technical. Therefore, it is very scoring and very, very mathematical. Simple go. Diminution of vision है, distortion of vision है, blurring of vision है, loss of vision है, macular pathology है, vitreous pathology है, floaters है या फिर distortion है. You have to go something like this. Okay, be very, very clear. Right. Now I am telling you how to read a OCT because certain diseases required OCT. Certain diseases required OCT. So let us see how to read a OCT. See, this is a normal OCT, guys, and everybody just in fractions will know how to read a OCT. I hope sir bhi dekh rahe hain and help karenge how to read a OCT. Ye dekho, jo red wala hai, this is actually the RPE layer. This is the RPE layer, and green is the neurosensory retina. This is the neurosensory retina. We know retina consists of two layers. One is the RPE and remaining nine layers are present in the neurosensory retina, having a gap in the middle. So this gap is called as a subretinal space. This is called as a subretinal space. And subretinal space में होता है subretinal fluid. ठीक है, ये simple है. Subretinal space में subretinal fluid, एक RPE layer है. Then we have a neurosensory retina having what in the center? Subretinal space, black wala, जिसमें क्या होगा? Subretinal fluid. Now you can see this gap here. This is called as foveal depression. This is called as the foveal depression. So this depression, why there is a depression? How many layers were there in the macula? We were having 10 layers in the macula, but fovea mein there are only 6 layers, and the center of the foveola hai, there we have only 5 layers. Therefore, we have the depression here. Therefore, we know that this area is a macula. Macula means all the 10 layers. So, this area is a macula. So, based on this, nahi, saans lene ka bhi time nahi hai. आज हम ऑफ्ता करके उठेंगे. ओके, सो सी दिस, अभी बहुत इंटरेस्टिंग आया है, अभी तो पजल करने की बारी आई है. सी दिस, सो दिस रेड इज द आरपीई लेयर. दिस रेड इज आरपीई लेयर. दिस इज द न्यूरोसेंसरी रेटिना एंड दिस इज अ फोवियल डिप्रेशन. नाउ वंस आई नो दैट दिस इज अ फोवियल डिप्रेशन, दिस एरिया इज अ मैक्यूला. नाउ कैन यू सी गाइज वॉट इज दिस? You can see this detachment in the macular area. Detachment in the macular area. Because we are having the detachment in the macular area, therefore this is CSR. CSR matlab business executive. CEO. If you are having CEO of the company, CFO of the company, business executive. Kya bataya tha maine? If the person is having 20 to 50 years of age, male, and type A personality. Type A personality क्या होता है? We have hurry, worry and curry. Those who are always in hurry, doing lot of worry and taking lot of curry, along with three S में we have stress, we have steroids and we have got the smoking. ये सब मिलकर क्या बना देता है? ये सब मिलके बना देता है बिजनेस एग्जीक्यूटिव. मतलब CSR इज इक्वल टू बिजनेस एग्जीक्यूटिव. सो बिजनेस एग्जीक्यूटिव में वेन एवर यू आर हैविंग द सडन लॉस ऑफ विजन एंड यू आर गेटिंग दिस काइंड ऑफ थिंग, देन इट इज एक्चुअली CSR. ये देखो, ब्यूटिफुल. वॉट इज इन्वेस्टिगेशन ऑफ चॉइस? इन्वेस्टिगेशन ऑफ चॉइस इज FFA. ये क्या है? ब्यूटिफुल मशरूम. So you can get a mushroom pattern. Investigation of choice में beautiful mushroom pattern मिल सकता है. या फिर what other thing you can get? The beautiful another one, ink blot pattern. Either you can get the mushroom pattern or you can get the ink blot pattern. Treatment क्या करना है? So the treatment what you have to do is just wait and watch. You have to do just wait and watch because there is spontaneous resolution in 4 to 12 weeks. Spontaneous resolution in 4 to 12 weeks. अब ये बहुत difficult है. एक बंदा आता है high profile का या business executive, he has lot of money, CEO है, CFO है, you are undergoing FFA, OCT, everything, and then we say कि just wait and your everything will be resolved. क्योंकि आजकल क्या होता है कि if you are getting anything in the report, then they are happy. And if you do not get anything report, they are angry. Then why did we get the report? They actually want that something should come in the report. But here the thing is that you get something in the report and then also we are asking him to wait and watch for spontaneous resolution. Yes or no? Okay. दूसरे पर आते हैं. अनदर इम्पोर्टेंट कंडीशन विच इज वेरी वेरी सिमिलर टू सी एस आर हेयर, दिस वन इज योर, यू कैन सी द सिस लाइक स्पेसिस इन द फंडस सीएमई. दिस इज कॉल्ड एज हनी कूम्ब अपियरेंस. दिस इज एक्चुअली एक रिफ्रेश्ड ईयर्स दैट विल एक्ट इज अ प्लेसिबो. ठीक है, तो हनी कूम्ब अपियरेंस वी आर गेटिंग द सिस लाइक स्पेसिस इन द फंडस. सिस लाइक स्पेसिस इन द फंडस, दिस इज एक्चुअली द सिस्टॉइड मैक्यूलर इडीमा. इडीमा मतलब फ्लूइड कलेक्शन. सिस्टॉइड मीन्स सिस्ट लाइक, मैक्यूला में एंड इडीमा इन विच लेयर्स अगेन इन द ओपन. ओपन मतलब इन द लेयर्स ऑफ आउटर प्लेक्सीफॉर्म एंड इनर न्यूक्लियर. एंड आउटर प्लेक्सीफॉर्म इज हेनलेज लेयर एंड हेनलेज लेयर कंटेन्स द पेटेलॉइड फाइबर्स. ये इसकी मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग है बिकॉज इट कंटेन्स द पेटल लाइक फाइबर्स. Therefore, the fluid will be accumulated petal-like. Therefore, dye will go petal-like and therefore you will get flower petal appearance. Again, a PYQ, the name of the Henle's layer along with the petaloid fibers along with the flower petal appearance. CSR versus CME hai. CME ka OCT dekho. You can see the cyst-like spaces here. These are the cyst-like spaces. So, ye jo cyst-like spaces hai, cystoid macular edema hai, honeycomb appearance in the fundus hai, and if you see the FFA, very very beautiful, beautiful flower petal appearance. The beautiful flower petal appearance in the cystoid macular edema, what is the treatment and what are the causes? Causes bahut zyada important hai. You have got many many risk factors. If you have, number one, it is associated with the retinitis pigmentosa. It can be associated with the uveitis. And which vitamin, guys, which vitamin can cause cystoid macular edema? Can I have the answers, please? Then it can be associated with the prostaglandin analogs. It can be associated with the CRVO. It can be associated with the cataract surgery. It can be associated with the cataract surgery. Then with the diabetic retinopathy and with the epinephrine, along with the epinephrine like this. Which vitamin? Yes, it is actually the niacin toxicity. So this is a question of NEET 2020. Which vitamin in the supraphysiological doses can cause the macular edema and the macular cyst? Macular edema and the macular cyst is actually caused by the niacin. Yes, epinephrine in aphakia, exactly. And obviously, because it is edema, so treatment will be the steroids. Therefore, the treatment will be the steroids. So, let us try to do a very, very important question on this. Ye dekho. Can you solve this question? A patient is taking the drugs for rheumatoid arthritis and is also having the history of cataract surgery 1 year back with the sudden painless loss of vision. Now, what I told you, whenever I say that the patient is having sudden painless, therefore, it is having something of the posterior segment. Usse pehle maine kya kiya hai? Whenever you get a question, please look at the image. So, look at the image and tell me what is this. You can see a flower petal appearance. Now, I know flower petal appearance matlab cystoid macular edema. Now, cystoid macular edema, can it occur after cataract surgery? Yes, it can occur. And see, our answer is cystoid macular edema. Otherwise, when you read this question that the patient is taking the drugs for rheumatoid arthritis, you may be thinking about chloroquine, hydroxychloroquine, and your mind is going towards the bullseye maculopathy and everything. But if you have looked at the image, you are not focusing on this. Rather, you are focusing on the cataract surgery and your answer is cystoid macular edema directly. ठीक है? Okay. Now see what is this? This is actually the Amsler grid. So another important test which is a macular function test. Amsler grid is a macular function test. Please look at this. It is a macular function test and there are two kind of patterns. See, this is a wavy pattern. You can see this wavy pattern. Wavy pattern is found in the macular diseases. Whenever we are having the macular diseases, we are going to have the wavy pattern. And another pattern that we can have. Another pattern is this one. This is the missing lines. This is the missing lines. If it is the missing lines, that means it is a optic nerve disease. Direct hai. If you are having a macular disease, wavy pattern, missing lines, then we are having the optic nerve disease. What is this? It is a macular function test. Amsler grid. Ye dekho. Another AIMS question. AIMS question 2017. And they had asked, what is this? So, now you know the retinal histology also. Hai na? Retina histology we know. So, can we name this? Ye dekho. You can see this lumen of the vessels here. So, this is the choroid. And what is the basal amino? What is the basal amino of the choroid called as? This is called as the Bruch's membrane. Basal amino of the choroid is a Bruch's membrane, while this one is the RPE layer, darkly pigmented. Darkly pigmented RPE layer ke baad kya tha? The layer of Rodgen-Cones. Rodgen-Cones will have outer segment, inner segment. Outer segment and inner segment hai. Uske baad you can see this is outer nuclear layer and this is the external limiting membrane. So what is this actually? Therefore, this is a drusen. Very, very important. Another histopathological question. You can see the retinal histology and you can easily answer. Now, if you know that this is a drusen, that means it is ARMD. What kind of ARMD? Dry ARMD. So, dry ARMD ka treatment is a multivitamin plus antioxidant. Now, they can ask you any question. They can ask you the name of this sign, the name of the disease, as well as the treatment also. Okay? This we have done. So, these are the drusens here. When you look them in the fundus, when you look them at the fundus, drusens look like this. Now, don't you think they resemble the hard exudates? This is a very, very important confusion that we actually have in our mind that they can be hard exudates. Now, how to differentiate? Now, see, if it is hard exudates, that means it can be a case of NPDR. That means it can be a case of NPDR. And if it is a case of NPDR, we can have microaneurysms, we can have dots, and we can have blots also. Okay, now you cannot see any hemorrhages here. Therefore, I know that this is not NPDR and therefore these are not hard exudates and we can say that these are drusens. So this is a very, very important thing with the help of which you can easily differentiate whether they are drusens or whether they are hard exudates. Alright, now coming to the most important thing in the retina. Most important thing in the retina, see this. A very, very important, you can say, ocular emergency. That is the retinal detachment. And we can have three kind of retinal detachment. One is the RRD. Then we have ERD. And then we have got the TRD. The most common is the RRD, you can see. And RRD means rigmatogenous. Now, the word rigmatogenous, if you see, regma. It is formed from the word regma and the... Ma'am, please explain the last one. Drusens. Okay, I'll come back to that. So, regma. Regma means retinal hole. So, basically, the RD which occurs due to retinal hole is actually rigmatogenous retinal detachment. You can see this is the retinal hole due to which the detachment is taking something like this and something like this. So, we are having this funnel-shaped RD. This funnel-shaped RD, whenever you are getting along with the retinal hole, is the rigmatogenous retinal detachment. We have got so many of the risk factors and always remember the investigation of the choice. Investigation of choice is the B scan ultrasound. Investigation of choice in the Best disease was different. Then in the CSR it was different. Then in the Stargardt disease it was different. Here it is B scan ultrasound. Okay. And you can see what is the meaning of this B scan. B matlab brightness. B means brightness. So, this is a brightness scan which is actually two-dimensional ultrasound. Agar B kaise hota hai? A aur B matlab 2. Iska matlab A scan is also there. A scan is one-dimensional ultrasound. So, you can easily differentiate A matlab pehla to one-dimensional ho gaya. B matlab dusra to two-dimensional ultrasound. Then that will be two-dimensional ultrasound. You can see this whenever you see the B scan. This one is the optic nerve shadow. This is a optic nerve shadow you are going to get and this is the detachment of the retina and this is a funnel that is formed. This is a funnel that is formed. So, you are going to get a funnel shaped RD in cases of rigmatogenous retinal detachment. Investigation of choice bhi ho gaya, B scan ultrasound and see the treatment. Treatment mein kya hai? RD detachment ho gaya. So, we are going to put something which is supporting the retina all around. So, we are putting the scleral buckle. Scleral buckle mein kya kar rahe hai? We are putting something all around the sclera. Agar ye hai, to we are putting something like this, scleral buckle all around. We are putting back the retina and then we are doing the suturing. This is actually called as the scleral buckling. This is called as, this one is the scleral buckle and this is called as the scleral buckling. This is actually called as the scleral buckling, the treatment of choice here. Now, another important thing, the second one, that is the ERD. E means exudative RD. So basically exudative RD can be three things. एक्सुडेटिव में क्या है, दैट समथिंग इज पुशिंग द रेटिना टुवर्ड्स विट्रियस कैविटी. तो जब भी वी आर पुशिंग एनीथिंग, वी कैन नॉट पुश इट इन अ कॉन्केव वे, वी हैव टू पुश इट इन अ कॉन्वेक्स वे ओनली. अब व्हाट इज पुशिंग दिस रेटिना, इट कैन बी एक्सुडेट, इट कैन बी एनी फ्लूइड, और इट कैन बी इवन ट्यूमर ऑल्सो, इट कैन बी ट्यूमर्स ऑल्सो. सो वेन एवर वी हैव फ्लूइड कलेक्शन, वेन एवर वी हैव ट्यूमर, वेन एवर वी हैव एक्सुडेट विद इन द लेयर्स ऑफ द रेटिना, दे आर पुशिंग द रेटिना, दे आर पुशिंग द रेटिना, देयर फोर यू आर गेटिंग दिस डूम शेप्ड आरडी. देयर फोर डूम शेप्ड आरडी, और इट इज कॉल्ड एज कॉन्वेक्स आरडी. वन वॉज अ फनल शेप्ड आरडी, वन वॉज अ डूम शेप्ड आरडी. इन्वेस्टिगेशन ऑफ चॉइस विल रिमेन सेम, दैट इज द बी स्कैन ऑन विच यू आर गोइंग टू गेट दिस डूम शेप्ड आरडी. वेल तीसरा क्या होगा, तीसरा पे टेंट है. टेंट क्या हो रहा है, दैट दिस आरडी इज कॉल्ड एज अ टीआरडी. टीआरडी मतलब ट्रैक्शनल आरडी. टीआरडी मीन्स ट्रैक्शनल आरडी. ट्रैक्शन मतलब पुल. सो यू आर पुलिंग द रेटिना टूवर्ड्स the vitreous cavity. अब जब भी हम किसी चीज को पुल करते हैं, how much it will be, how it will be done. So see, whenever I am pulling something, it is something like this. So you cannot pull in a concave manner. It is something like this. So a tent is formed. This therefore this is also called as a tent shape RD. So one is funnel shaped RD, one is convex RD, and one is the concave RD. Concave RD or the tent shape RD. Now this something which is pulling the retina, so it has to be strong. Strong kya ho jayega, dense vitreous hemorrhage. So dense vitreous hemorrhage in the vitreous cavity can pull the retina. Vitreous hemorrhage kahan se hoga, from the PDR, from the Hill's disease, from the trauma, from the ROP, and we can have pulling of the retina. So three different types of the retinal detachment with the three different configuration on the B scan ultrasound. Now finally a very important thing, and take my words, this is also 2023. Another important thing is that 2023, can you see what is this, guys? What is this? This is actually the leukochorea. You can see leukochorea or the whitish pupillary reflex. Now another important mathematical thing, leukochorea ka most common cause and the most severe cause. Theek hai na? They are very very different. Most common different hai, most severe dusra hai. Most common is always cataract. Most common cause of leukochorea is cataract, while most severe is the retinoblastoma. Don't confuse. And dusra, every time I tell you that the most common and the most severe are never same. They are never never same. Most common are always different and most severe are always different. Nature has always made this balance. Jo bhi most severe hota hai, that is never never most common. Now the presentation. So we know that the most common presentation is the leukochorea. Now what are the other presentations of leukochorea? I can have unilateral leukochorea, I can have bilateral also. Then second, we can also have squint. First was the leukochorea, second is the squint, and third we can also have the glaucoma in the baby. So buftal moss leke bhi aa sakta hai. So if your baby is having the buftal moss but it is unilateral, then think of the retinoblastoma. Apart from this, we can also have the pseudo uveitis and the pseudo hypopyon. Now sometimes this can present as an inflammation. It is mimicking the inflammation, therefore it is pseudo uveitis or the pseudo hypopyon. Then it can present as a swelling called as orbital inflammation, and we can also have the orbital invasion. So all these are the different presentations of the retinoblastoma. First is leukochorea, second is a squint, third is glaucoma, then we have others. And what is the trilateral retinoblastoma? What is trilateral retinoblastoma? Whenever we have bilateral retinoblastoma along with the pineoblastoma, very very important. And I think there was a question on the RB gene also, and this is very very important of the plus patho, because you read about the Knudsen 2 hit hypothesis, you read about the RB gene here also. Then ophtha plus pediatrics, unilateral dense cataract can be there, unilateral diminution of vision can be there, along with the pseudo uveitis, you can have that kind of thing also. Another important thing, ophtha plus patho, can you recognize the type of the rosettes, the two types? Staging is not important, like you don't have to cram actual stages of the retinoblastoma. Gene, you know, 13q14, and Knudsen 2 hit hypothesis, you know. Then can you tell me what are the kind of rosettes that you are getting here, where you are seeing the empty lumen? If you are able to see the empty lumen, these are the Flexner Wintersteiner rosettes. Again patho, Flexner Wintersteiner rosettes. And what, and what if you are not able to see the lumen? If you are not able to see the lumen, then it is the Homer Wright rosette. then it is the Homer right rosettes. Okay, now what is the other thing that we can do? As I told you that the you don't have to cram the staging, but investigations are important. Like, we can do so many things for the retinoblastoma. We can do the B scan, we can do CT scan, we can also do MRI. Now, which do you think is the investigation of choice, guys? Please write it in the comment section. What do you think should be the investigation of choice? Because I can do the B scan. Whenever we have tumors, we have calcification, and calcification ke liye to best is CT scan. But actually, this is not the investigation of choice, and it is the MRI that is the investigation of choice, for the obvious reason, because I do not want to give the radiation exposure to a small child, and that is the reason that we are not preferring the CT scan. So I can do the B scan. No, guys, no, Adiba, it's not the CT scan, it is actually the MRI, because I can see the nerve involvement, I can also appreciate the calcification, while in cases of the CT scan we are going to give the radiation exposure. So always remember, MRI is the investigation of choice. So how was your retina ride? We have completed all the 100 images of the fundus. Please see if you have understood. And next we are going to move towards the neuro-ophtha. Neuro-ophthalmic, we have to do the visual pathway defects for sure. So let's try to do the visual pathway defects. Okay. So let's get started from the optic nerve, and you people have to support me. You have to tell me the things. Sabse pehle we start with the optic nerve. Optic nerve se. Yes. So optic nerve mein, and for the ease of understanding, I am taking the right sided lesions. We are taking the right sided lesions of the optic nerve. So agar right side ka, अगर राइट साइड की ऑप्टिक नर्व गई है गाइस, तो क्या होगा? राइट साइड के नेजल भी गए, राइट साइड के टेम्पोरल भी गए, तो विजुअल फील्ड डिफेक्ट कैसा होगा वो बना देते हैं. बिकॉज यू नो, यूजुअली दे आर गिविंग यू द पिक्टोरियल डायग्राम, सो आई एम मोर इंटरेस्टेड इन द पिक्टोरियल डायग्राम. अभी ये समझना, रूट ऑफ स्प्रेड पे. अच्छा हाँ, रूट ऑफ स्प्रेड की एक बात बता देती हूँ. कैन वी डू द पार्क 3 स्टेप टेस्ट? तो वी विल डू इट आफ्टर, राइट आफ्टर दिस, है ना? तो यू हैव टू कीप योर एनर्जीज हाईज एंड वी विल बी देयर विद दैट. ठीक है ना, वो भी हम अभी करेंगे. मोस्ट कॉमन रूट ऑफ स्प्रेड फॉर द रेटिनोब्लास्टोमा इज अ डायरेक्ट स्प्रेड बाय द ऑप्टिक नर्व. अब अगर दोनों दे रखे हैं, गो विद द ऑप्टिक नर्व, राइट, डायरेक्ट. ठीक है ना, हाउ मच लेफ्ट? इट्स वेरी स्मॉल पार्ट इज लेफ्ट. ओके, थोड़ा सा पेशेंस और रखो, होने वाला है. तो ऑप्टिक नर्व पे चलते हैं. ऑप्टिक नर्व में राइट साइडेड, we are having the right sided optic nerve defect. अभी क्या है? Yes, तो बहुत बार आता है visual pathway defects, इसीलिए हम कर रहे हैं. Now सबसे बड़ी बात यह है कि when you have to read it, this is your right eye and this is your left eye, and you have to divide this into two parts. This is temporal, nasal, nasal and temporal. Now when you read the visual defects, you have to take it as if it is your field. So your right side will be the right eye field and your left side will be the left eye field. See, when we examine the patient, patient is in front of me, so it is the opposite side. But when you consider their fields, then it is as if your own field. So your right side will be the right eye and left side will be the left eye. So if the right side optic nerve lesion will be there, then obviously we will have complete blindness in the right eye while we will have normal vision in the left eye. It could be something like this. So any lesion of the optic nerve will give me something like this. If I have right eye optic nerve lesion, complete blindness on the right side. Left eye optic nerve lesion, complete blindness on the left eye. Now the second one, whenever we are having the lesions of the optic eyes, my ye bahut dhyan se dekhna. I think this is the most commonly asked PYQ hai, especially in AIIMS also. Very very important. Now whenever I am saying chiasma, chiasma kya hai? Nasal fibers. Nasal kya hote hai? Nasal fibers are decussating. So as I always tell you in the classes also, that the nasal fibers will be coming from the opposite side and the temporal fibers will remain on the same side. So kisi bhi side ke optic tract mein, you will have same side temporal fibers and you will have opposite side nasal fibers. So agar optic chiasma hai, तो व्हाट इज गोइंग टू अफेक्टेड, बाइलेटरल नेजल फाइबर्स. अगर नेजल फाइबर्स अफेक्ट हुए हैं दोनों साइड के, सो व्हाट इज गोइंग टू बी अफेक्टेड, इट इज द टेम्पोरल फील्ड ऑफ बोथ दी आईज. देयरफॉर टेम्पोरल फील्ड ऑफ दिस आई एंड टेम्पोरल फील्ड ऑफ दिस आई. अब वो दूसरा है कि दिस विल रिमेन राइट आई ओनली एंड दिस विल रिमेन लेफ्ट आई. सो यू आर गोइंग टू डिवाइड दिस इंटू टू हाफ. देयरफॉर वी विल हैव टेम्पोरल फील्ड ऑफ दिस आई which will be affected and the temporal field of this eye also which is going to be affected, something like this, temporal field of this eye as well as temporal field of this eye. Okay, because we are going to get the lesion of bilateral nasal fibers, therefore temporal field of this eye and temporal field of this eye, वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. वाइल अगर हम इसका उल्टा कर दें, उल्टा मतलब इफ आई एम हैविंग द लीजन ऑफ द बाइलैटरल लैटरल काइज्मा, सो दैट मीन्स विच फाइबर्स आर गेटिंग अफेक्टेड. इफ आई एम हैविंग द लीजन ऑफ बाइलैटरल लैटरल काइज्मा, लैटरल काइज्मा मतलब लैटरल टू द ऑप्टिक काइज्मा, सो व्हाट इज गोइंग टू बी अफेक्टेड इज द बाइलैटरल टेम्पोरल फाइबर्स. So what is affected is bilateral temporal fibers and temporal fibers will affect the nasal field. So you are going to get diagonally opposite. That means nasal field of this eye and the nasal field of this eye. You are going to get something like this, right eye field, left eye field, temporal, nasal, temporal and nasal. So now it is the nasal field of this eye which is going to be affected as well as nasal field of this eye is also going to be affected, something like this. Nasal field of this eye as well as nasal field of this eye, this will be called as the binasal hemianopia. Okay, now up till now we are having the crossing over, but now we come to the lesions of the optic tract. Now we come to the lesions of the optic tract, and you have to understand the simple thing. Whenever we are having the lesions of the optic tract, it will contain the ipsilateral temporal fibers, ipsilateral temporal fibers and the contralateral nasal fibers. So temporal fibers will remain on the same side, nasal fibers of the opposite side. अब अगर वी आर कंसिडरिंग द राइट ऑप्टिक ट्रैक, तो सिंपल है. राइट ऑप्टिक ट्रैक मतलब राइट के टेम्पोरल फाइबर्स एंड लेफ्ट के नेजल फाइबर्स. इफ राइट के टेम्पोरल फाइबर्स आर अफेक्टेड, देयरफॉर राइट का नेजल विजुअल फील्ड, एंड इफ द लेफ्ट के नेजल फाइबर्स आर अफेक्टेड, देन इट इज लेफ्ट का टेम्पोरल विजुअल फील्ड. सो लेट अस ट्राई टू ड्रॉ इट एंड सी विच टाइप ऑफ फील्ड इफेक्ट इट इज. तो फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम वी आर गोइंग टू गेट दिस. For the first time we are going to get this. Now we are going to get something like this. ये हो गया right eye और ये हो गया left eye. Right की nasal field is getting affected and left की temporal field is getting affected. So this is actually contralateral homonymous hemianopia. Contralateral homonymous hemianopia, and this is also the most common defect. ये सबसे ज्यादा important है. Because you know, from here up to the visual cortex, the configuration of the fibers will remain same. Matlab temporal fibers will remain on the same side only, and the nasal fibers will come from the contralateral side. That means from the opposite side, and they will remain so from here up to the visual cortex. So yahan se leke visual cortex tak, you are going to get the same. That is contralateral homonymous hemianopia. Contralateral homonymous hemianopia. Iske baad kya hai? Number 5 pe we can have the lateral geniculate body. Number 6 pe we have the optic radiations. Number 6 pe we are also having the optic radiations, and number 7 pe we are also having the visual cortex. So it will remain same. Contralateral homonymous hemianopia. If I say a female coming with the right side of both the eyes getting blind, so matlab it is right homonymous hemianopia. Right homonymous matlab we get contralateral homonymous hemianopia. Iska matlab defect kaha ho jayega left mein. So you don't have to actually draw it in the exam. Just from the question itself you can see, if I am getting right sided homonymous hemianopia, defect is in the left optic tract, and if I am getting left homonymous hemianopia, defect is in the right optic. ऑप्टिक ट्रैक. तो ड्रॉ करने की जरूरत नहीं है, वहां पे डायरेक्ट गो विद अ वर्ड एंड यूल गेट द आंसर. वेरी वेरी सिंपल है. नाउ वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इज वन थिंग, द ऑप्टिक रेडिएशन डिफेक्ट. दिस ऑप्टिक रेडिएशन डिफेक्ट कैन बी डिवाइडेड इनटू द पाई इन द स्काई, pie in the sky as well as pie in the floor. This is again very very important PYQs. Whenever I am getting hemianopia, agar hemianopia hai, this can be divided into two quadrants, superior quadrant, inferior quadrant. So pie in the sky, sky means superior quadrant enopia, and pie in the floor, floor matlab inferior quadrant enopia. Superior is found in the temporal lobe lesions, ST, and inferior is found in the parietal lobe lesion. So remember it by the ST. ST elevation hota hai. ST elevation se yaad rakho, PI, peripheral iridectomy hoti hai. Parietal mein inferior milta hai. Just this. See, if you know that from the rationale, you know that temporal lobe contains the inferior fibers, parietal lobe contains the superior fibers. But just for remembering, you can remember it like this, that we have a ST elevation. ST elevation matlab superior mein temporal lobe ka ho jata hai, and then we have got the inferior. Inferior fibers are affected in the parietal lobe, therefore we will have the superior fibers are affected, therefore we will have inferior quadrant enopia. Now another very very important thing, we have got the macular sparing. So macular sparing pe bhi also we had a question once. Whenever we have a thing in the macular sparing, ye dekho. So visual cortex mein, now another ophtha plus anatomy. Ophtha plus anatomy ki agar hum baat kare, visual cortex blood supply is by posterior cerebral artery. Now posterior cerebral artery is supplying whole of the visual cortex except the center. Center is having the double blood supply. This center is the macula, and macula is having the double blood supply. Double blood supply mein kya hoga? If I am having the lesion of this posterior cerebral artery, so whole of the peripheral area will become blind. So whole of the peripheral area will become blind, but the central area, that is the macular area, will continue to have vision because it is having the double blood supply. Bahut hi beautiful sa ban jayega. Keyhole vision, as if you are seeing through a keyhole. So only central area will be visible through it, something like this and something like this. Because of the double blood supply, we are going to have the vision only in the central area. This is actually called as macular sparing. So macular sparing word agar aata hai, that means it's a lesion of the occipital cortex, occipital lobe or the visual cortex, pie in the sky, pie in the floor, temporal lobe, parietal lobe, contralateral homonymous hemianopia from the level of optic tract, optic chiasma and lateral chiasma mein, bitemporal and binasal. And if you are getting the lesions of the optic nerve, you will get the total blindness on the side of lesion and the normal vision on the other side. So above the sulcus and below the sulcus mein nahi jana hai, directly jana hai. Lateral geniculate body mein again you are going to get the contralateral homonymous hemianopia. Simple rakho, be very very simple. Optic nerve mein total enopia on that side, normal vision on the other side. Agar optic chiasma hai to bitemporal, lateral chiasma mein binasal, and uske baad mein it is contralateral homonymous hemianopia. That's it, contralateral homonymous hemianopia. All right. Now a very very important thing. The next one we are going to do is the Park 3 step test. Sabka favorite Park 3 step test kar lete hai. So we will do it with the help of example. A simple example lete hai. If the patient is having the right eye ka hypertropia. Right eye hypertropia, increasing in the right gaze and in the right head tilt. And the right head tilt. Right hypertropia increasing in the right gaze and the right head tilt. Ab iske three parts hai. Simple dekhte hai. We are having the three parts here. Three parts alag alag kaise solve karenge. One is the right hypertropia. Second is increasing in the right gaze and third in the right head tilt. Teen steps hain, three different things hain. To pehla step number one leke chalte hain, step number one. Theek hai na? Agar hum one by one karenge, the life will become very very simple, and there are no many combinations of this question. So you have to practice really one combination and you are going to get through. Theek hai na? Number one is, I am saying that there is a right eye ka hypertropia. If the right eye ka hypertropia hai, then there are can be two options. Either right eye is absolutely going into hypertropia, ya phir dusra left eye is going into hypotropia. Right eye hypertropia mein chala gaya, या लेफ्ट आई हाइपो में चला गया, देन ऑल्सो इट इज रिलेटिव राइट आई हाइपरट्रोपिया. तो स्टेप नंबर वन में हमेशा यू हैव टू कंसिडर बाय योर सेल्फ. मैम इट विल नॉट बी गिवन इन द क्वेश्चन, येस दे विल गिव यू ओनली वन थिंग, बट यू हैव टू कंसिडर इट बाई योर सेल्फ दैट इफ दे हैव गिवन यू राइट आई का हाइपरट्रोपिया, इट कैन ऑल्सो बी लेफ्ट आई का हाइपोट्रोपिया. ये आपको खुद से लेना है. नाउ वंस यू हैव टेकन दिस, राइट आई इज गोइंग अप, दैट मीन्स देर इज अ डिप्रेसर पाल्सी. There is a depressor palsy in this eye. Other eye, yes, definitely you will get the PDF. Okay, left eye ka hypotropia. Agar iska hypotropia hai, that means we are getting a elevator palsy. That means it's a elevator palsy. So one ka depressor hai, one ka elevator hai. Now what are the depressors of right eye? Fastest fingers first, देखते हैं what are the depressors of the right eye. Right eye के depressors में right का inferior rectus and right का superior oblique. What are the elevators of the left eye? Elevators of the left eye में left का superior rectus and the left का inferior oblique. ये देखो step number वन. And सबसे मजेदार बात क्या है, that all the four will be given to you in the question. So you can actually check your step number one from the options given, whether you are getting the right options or not, because usually they will give you all these four options in the question itself. Now this is your step number one. Coming to the step number two, it increase in the right gaze. It is increasing in the right gaze. So when the patient sees towards the right gaze, it is increasing. That means there is a limitation of the motility. So let us make this patient look towards the right, something like this and something like this. So this eye will adduct and this eye will abduct. One eye is adducting and one eye is abducting. When I want to see towards right, my left eye will adduct and my right eye will abduct. Now you have to always remember that in the abducting eye mein we have to choose the rectus muscle, and in the adducting eye, in cases of the adducting eye, we have to choose the obliques. Theek hai na? This is a simple theorem that you have to remember. So in the abducting may choose the rectus, in the adducting oblique. So in the adducting you have to choose the oblique. Ye dekho 50-50 lifeline mil gayi, do asani se remove ho gaye. Now you are left only with two muscles, right ka inferior rectus and left ka inferior oblique. Now applying the step number three. Applying the step number three, you have to find out only one muscle. It is increase in the right head tilt. It is increasing in the right head tilt. So when the person is doing the right head tilt, in order to maintain the balance, if you go with the vestibulo-ocular reflex. Vestibulo-ocular reflex says that whenever we are tilting the head towards one side, the eyes will go in the opposite side, something like. Okay, step ka kya meaning hai? Is step ka kya meaning hai? Step ka meaning hai ki there is a limitation of the movement of the eyes when they are doing the right gaze. Matlab jab right gaze mein dekhenge, so there is a limitation of this eye or this eye. Theek hai? Now third is that it is increasing in the right head tilt. When the head is going towards right, eyes will go towards opposite side. So if the head is going towards the right, eyes are going towards the left side. Kuch is tarah se. Hamesha eyes will move towards opposite side. Ab look at this. Dekho, right eye is going towards left. So this will be in torsion. Theek hai? And left eye is also going towards left. This is actually extorsion. This is actually extorsion. तो अगर हम head right में ले जा रहे हैं, eyes are going towards left side, so this eye will intort and this eye will extort, and you know that superiors are intortus. Simple है, superiors are intortus and both of them are inferior muscles. दोनों ही inferior muscles है, therefore you don't have to choose the intorsion. So therefore answer will be the LIO. Therefore now yes, don't confuse, bada bada main likh rahi hu, don't confuse with rad. here you don't have to apply the red. Red is for the tertiary action. यहाँ पे हम बात कर रहे हैं primary और secondary actions की, that is maximum elevation and depression in the eye which is already adducting is done by obliques. Maximum elevation and depression in our eye which is abducting is actually done by the rectus. So don't confuse it with the red. यहाँ पर red नहीं होगा. अच्छा, अब इसका ट्रिक क्या है? देखो, ऑब्वियसली इट विल टेक सम टाइम, बट द थिंग इज दैट यू हैव टू गो इन थ्री स्टेप्स. यू हैव टू सी दैट वन आई इज गोइंग इन टू हाइपरट्रोपिया एंड वन आई इज गोइंग इन टू हाइपरट्रोपिया. तो एक में डिप्रेसर पालसी है, एक में एलिवेटर पालसी है. देन यू हैव टू थिंक. सो ऑब्वियसली दिस विल टेक सम टाइम बिकॉज देर इज नो डायरेक्ट ट्रिक. यू हैव टू गो स्टेप बाय स्टेप. लेकिन सबसे अच्छी बात क्या है दैट यू डू नॉट हैव मेनी कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन. सो आफ्टर दिस आई कैन सेंड यू द 4 to 5 कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ द पार्क 3 स्टेप टेस्ट विच आर एक्चुअली पॉसिबल एंड स्टार्ट प्रैक्टिसिंग देम. सो वेन यू आर प्रैक्टिसिंग द सेम कॉम्बिनेशन 4 to 5 कॉम्बिनेशन मल्टीपल टाइम्स यू विल बी एबल टू गेट द आंसर. ओके, सो डोंट वरी अबाउट दैट. So this is about your Park 3 step test. Now another important thing, वो भी मैं orally कराऊंगी, and that is your question on the astigmatism. The question on the astigmatism we will do here, and I will tell you how to do this question on the astigmatism. This actually came in NEET 2018. Simple question है, which of the following is an example of Which of the following is an example of compound myopic against the rule? अब सबसे पहली चीज that you have to do is that you don't have to tell it directly. इसमें jump नहीं करना है that this is compound myopic astigmatism. First we have to convert this into retinoscopic finding. तो how to convert this into retinoscopic finding वो देख लेते हैं. Let's see the option number 1. Yes. So I am going to answer your questions. Just have patience for 5-10 minutes and then I am going to answer your questions also. A पर चलते हैं. It is -2 diopter spherical and -2 diopter cylinder at 180 degree. It is 180 degree, ये देखो. तो whenever I say I have to convert this into retinoscopic finding, -2 is a diopter spherical and -2 is a diopter cylinder. Self refillable है. आपको पता नहीं है ऑप्था वालों का कब तो खुद से भर जाता है. अभी मैं अगर 4 घंटे और भी पढ़ूंगी तो इट विल गो ऑन रिफिलिंग बाय इटसेल्फ. ऑलराइट, सो हाउ टू कन्वर्ट दिस इनटू रेटिनोस्कोपिक फाइंडिंग. -2 इज अ स्फेरिकल. स्फेरिकल मतलब इक्वल इन ऑल द मेरिडियन. सो -2 हियर आल्सो एंड -2 हियर आल्सो. -2 डायोप्टर सिलेंडर एट 180. नाउ द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग इज दैट व्हेनेवर वी आर गिविंग अ सिलेंडर द पावर विल ऑलवेज एक्ट एट अ परपेंडिकुलर प्लेन. सो 180 मतलब हॉरिजॉन्टल. सो इफ आई एम गिविंग एट हॉरिजॉन्टल इट विल एक्ट एट वर्टिकल. सो -2 विल एड हियर. सो फाइनली व्हाट यू आर गेटिंग इज -4 एंड -2. नाउ कैन यू सी इज इट एस्टिग्मेटिज्म? यस, बिकॉज वी आर हैविंग डिफरेंट पावर इन बोथ द मेरिडियंस. डिफरेंट पावर इन बोथ द मेरिडियंस मतलब इट इज एस्टिग्मेटिज्म. It is minus, therefore it is myopic and no meridian is zero. We are not having any emmetropic. So this is compound. Compound myopic astigmatism. -4 is more than -2. Matlab vertical is more than horizontal. Therefore it is with the rule astigmatism. Simple. So this is compound myopic astigmatism with the rule. But in the question they are asking compound myopic against the rule. Okay. Then number two is the -2 diopter spherical and -1 diopter cylinder at the 90 degree. Now can you tell me the answer? Orally करेंगे. Now we are going to do it orally. -2 diopter spherical. Spherical मतलब equal in both the meridians. -2 here also and -2 here also. And -1 at 90 degree मतलब vertically. तो -2 and -1. See इतना maths every bio student can do. -2 and -1 is -3. तो -3 हो गया and -2 this. -2 and -3 is a compound myopic astigmatism. And you know -3 is more. -3 is more than -2. So see this is compound myopic astigmatism against the rule. Compound myopic astigmatism against the rule. Video stuck. Okay, just a second. I think you can hear me. Video will be resuming soon. Just a second. Till then, please do this third one and tell me what is the type of astigmatism. Please see what is the type of astigmatism in the C. Plus 2 diopter spherical and minus 2 diopter cylinder at the 90 degree. Plus 2 is a spherical, therefore equal in both the meridians. And minus 2 is you are giving at 90 degree. Minus 2 you are giving at 90. That means you are giving at vertical and therefore it will act at horizontal. So we are having something like this. Plus 2 here also. And plus 2 here also. And minus 2 you are giving at 90 degree. Therefore it will act at 180 degree. So plus 2 and minus 2 will cancel out. And it will become plus 2 and 0. Plus 2 and 0. Therefore what is the type of astigmatism? Just a second, we are redoing the camera. Video is stuck. Just a second. Yes, so this means we are getting the plus 2 here and 0 here. Therefore, this is simple hypermetropic astigmatism. Now, what is the power? What is the type? Always remember, minus power is more than 0 power and 0 power is more than plus power. So, here 0 will be more than plus. Therefore, it is against the rule. Therefore, it is against the rule. So, you can do it orally. अभी fourth option में हम orally करेंगे. Minus 2 diopter spherical at 90 degree. Minus 2 diopter spherical at 90 मतलब you are giving at vertically. So, it will act horizontally. So, vertical will be 0 and this will be minus 2. 1 is 0 मतलब this is emetropic. Therefore, this is simple astigmatism. Another is minus. So, simple myopic astigmatism. It is 0 and minus 2. Minus is more. So, it is against the rule. Therefore, it is simple myopic astigmatism against the rule. Simple, I am repeating this. Whenever you are having the spherical one, spherical will be equal in both the meridians and cylinder will be acting at a particular degree at the perpendicular axis. So, if I am saying minus 2 spherical, so minus 2 will act here also and minus 2 will act here also. Cylinder, if you are giving at horizontal 180, then this will act at 90. So, see now you have got minus 4 and minus 2. Therefore, it is compound myopic astigmatism with the rule. And if horizontal is more, then you will say it is against the rule. So, I think you have understood this. It's like Alia Bhatt giving the off the class voiceover. Oh, I do not know if I, my voice is like Alia Bhatt. Okay, all right, so I think you have understood this, guys. So the most important things I think we have done, we had started with the visual acuity, all the important images of the lens, all the important things in the glaucoma, retina, squint and neuro-ophtha. Okay, all the important concepts we have done. Now, after the session, you will actually you will actually get the PDF of all these things. And one more thing, I will share the PDF of the cornea and conjunctiva also, because that is just the small notes. In addition to this, you can have a read over that also. And you are done with the whole of the ophthalmology. Vertical greater is, yes, that means whenever you are having vertical meridian power more than horizontal, then it is called as with the rule. And if the power in horizontal is more than vertical, then it is called as against the rule. Then it is called as against the rule. Now, how to understand whether it is simple astigmatism or it is compound? Whether it is compound astigmatism and whether it is mixed astigmatism? Simple. Simple matlab simple. When you are having any one meridian as emmetropic and another is either minus or plus. Compound matlab either both minus or it is both plus. So either it is compound myopic astigmatism or it is compound hypermetropic astigmatism. Mix matlab one is minus and one is plus. Okay. Uveitis mein we have covered the acute anterior uveitis as the acute red eye, that is important. Then cover test. Achha. चलो तो एक चीज और इम्पोर्टेंट बताती हूँ फ्रॉम द कॉर्नियल अल्सर्स. ठीक है ना, बहुत ही सिंपल है. अगेन यू नो मैथमेटिकल फॉर्मूला आई विल टेल यू फॉर सॉल्विंग द कॉर्नियल अल्सर्स, जस्ट मैथमेटिकल है. सी वी आर हैविंग फोर टाइप ऑफ अल्सर्स. एक तरफ वी आर हैविंग द बैक्टीरियल, फिर है फंगल, देन वी हैव वायरल एंड वी हैव एकैंथमीबा. ठीक है ना. So, whenever we have the corneal ulcers and you have to find out whether it is bacterial, whether it is fungal, whether it is viral or acanthamoeba, simple hai, bacterial will be presenting as a acute red eye. This will be presenting with the acute red eye. We will have pain, we will have the hypopyon. We will also have the hypopyon, which is always sterile as well as always mobile. Always sterile also and always mobile also. ठीक है. While on the other hand, if you are having fungal, F for fungal and F for finger like projections. And we have the finger like projections. Now here because we are having finger like projections, therefore F for fixed. Therefore we have fixed hypopyon. Therefore we are going to have fixed hypopyon. Fixed matlab because these finger like projections are going inside these pus cells. Therefore this hypopyon will be non sterile as well as non mobile. ठीक है, इट इज जस्ट द ऑपोजिट, नॉन स्टेराइल एंड नॉन मोबाइल. एफ फॉर फिंगर लाइक प्रोजेक्शन, एफ फॉर फिक्सड हो गया. प्लस इन द फंगस वॉट विल हैपन, साइंस विल बी मोर देन द सिम्टम्स. ऑलवेज साइंस आर मोर देन सिम्टम्स. तो एक होता है वन मेंबर ऑफ द फैमिली इज वेरी वेरी एंग्री टाइप. अगेन आई थिंक इट इज स्टक, बट आई थिंक यू आर हियरिंग माई वॉइस. सो जस्ट अ सेकेंड, इट विल कम. One member of the family is something who is very very angry type and you are getting scolding. So that is actually the bacterial ulcer, but the fungal ulcers are the silent killers. So they will have the finger like projections, you will have multiple satellite lesions, you will have fixed hypopyons, always non-sterile and non-mobile, and signs are always more than the symptoms. Then comes the viral. अब viral क्या होते हैं? They are very very stubborn. Stubborn because they will always go and they will hide inside the trigeminal ganglions. Trigeminal ganglion is the sensory supply of the eye, and because it is the sensory supply of the eye, therefore decrease corneal sensation. तो अगर हम third देखेंगे towards the viral ulcers, you will always get decreased corneal sensations. And what is the typical type of lesions in the viral? You will get the dendritic ulcers. So agar dendritic ulcers hai and decreased corneal sensations hai, always think about the viral ulcers. While fourth wala aa jata hai, fourth wala is the acanthamoeba. Abhi acanthamoeba mein kya hai? It is ARC. जैसे होता है ना abnormal retinal correspondence, उससे याद रखना है ARC accommodation. It is the abnormal retinal correspondence. So A for acanthamoeba, then R say you will get the ring abscess. You are going to get the ring abscess, and R for the radial keratoneuritis also. R for radial keratoneuritis, and then we have C, सी फॉर द कॉन्टेक्ट लेंसेज. तो सिंपल है एकांथमीबा में, इफ यू आर हैविंग एकांथमीबा, आर फॉर रिंग एब्सेस है, आर फॉर रेडियल केराटोन्यूराइटिस है, सी फॉर कॉन्टेक्ट लेंसेज है, एंड यू आर गोइंग टू गेट पेन विच इज आउट ऑफ प्रपोर्शन. वी आर गोइंग टू गेट द पेन विच इज आउट ऑफ प्रपोर्शन टू द साइज ऑफ द अल्सर. तो एक बैक्टीरियल था जिसमें पेन इन प्रपोर्शन टू साइज ऑफ अल्सर है, फंगल है वेयर साइंस आर मोर देन द सिम्टम्स है, वायरल है डिक्रीज कॉर्नियल सेंसेशन विद द डेंड्रिटिक अल्सर, एंड नंबर फोर इज एकांथमीबा हैविंग द कॉन्टेक्ट लेंसेज विद पेन आउट ऑफ प्रपोर्शन टू द साइज ऑफ अल्सर. ओके, सो वी आर गोइंग टू गेट दिस केएफ रिंग फॉर्मड इन द लिम्बस और इन द कॉर्निया मैम. सो पेन पेन कह रही हूं दैट के एफ रिंग इज प्रेजेंट एक्चुअली इन द डेस्मेंस मेम्ब्रेन. सो इट इज टुवर्ड्स द लिम्बस बट नॉट एग्जैक्टली एट द लिम्बस. इन टू द लिम्बस यू आर गोइंग टू गेट फर्स्ट इन द सुपीरियर एंड इन्फीरियर क्वाड्रेंट. ओके, एंड सिंपेथेटिक ऑफ्थेल्माइटिस. सिंपेथेटिक ऑफ्थेल्माइटिस जस्ट तीन लाइन लिखाऊंगी और उसी में से आएगा. इट इज बाइलेटरल ग्रैन्युलोमेटस पैन्यूवियाइटिस. बायोलेटरल ग्रैनुलोमेटस पैन यूवियाइटिस है, तो टाइप ऑफ यूवियाइटिस इंपॉर्टेंट है. इट्स अ काइंड ऑफ पैन यूवियाइटिस. देन इट इज अकरिंग ड्यू टू द ट्रॉमा. नेक्स्ट ट्रॉमा इंपॉर्टेंट है. ट्रॉमा कैन बी पेनिट्रेटिंग ट्रॉमा, इट कैन बी पेनिट्रेटिंग और इट कैन बी परफोरेटिंग. इट कैन बी पेनिट्रेटिंग ट्रॉमा और परफोरेटिंग ट्रॉमा ऑफ द सीलरी बॉडी विच इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज द डेंजरस डेंजरस एरिया ऑफ द आई. सो इतना काफी है, इसी से आएगा. पैन यूवियाइटिस 2022 में आया है, पेनिट्रेटिंग ट्रॉमा 2020 में आया है, सिंपेथेटिक ऑफ्थेल्माइटिस. नाउ डोंट बी ग्रीडी, आई थिंक दिस इज मोर देन इनफ है, इतना काफी है. डिफरेंस बिटवीन द स्फाइलोमा एंड द स्क्लेरोमलेशिया परफोरेंस, एक मिनट वो भी दिखा देती हूं. द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द स्क्लेरोमलेशिया परफोरेंस एंड द स्टेफाइलोमा. स्टेफाइलोमा बहुत डिफरेंट है. ये देखो स्टेफाइलोमा का मतलब क्या होता है. स्टेफाइलोमा वर्ड इज फॉर्म फ्रॉम द वर्ड स्टेफाइलो. स्टेफाइलोस मतलब बंच ऑफ ग्रेप लाइक अपेयरेंस. सो यू आर गेटिंग बंच ऑफ ग्रेप लाइक अपेयरेंस इन द सीलरी एरिया, देन इट इज सीलरी स्टेफाइलोमा. कॉर्निया में इट इज एंटीरियर स्टेफाइलोमा. स्क्लेरा में है पोस्टीरियर स्टेफाइलोमा. जबकि स्क्लेरोमलेशिया परफोरेंस, एक तो स्क्लेरोमलेशिया परफोरेंस इज अ टाइप ऑफ स्क्लेराइटिस. स्क्लेराइटिस यूजली एसोसिएटेड विद द कनेक्टिव टिश्यू डिसऑर्डर. सो यू विल गेट अ हिस्ट्री ऑफ एल्डरली फीमेल अलॉन्ग विद द रूमेटॉइड आर्थराइटिस. उसके अलावा स्क्लेराइटिस है इसलिए ब्लैकिश एरिया होगा. प्लस यू विल नॉट गेट ओनली वन एरिया, जैसे सीलरी स्टेफाइलोमा ओनली वन एरिया, यहां पे मल्टीपल एरियाज ऑल्सो होंगे. प्लस द हिस्ट्री विल ऑल्सो टेल यू. इफ अगर इफ इट इज अ क्वेश्चन ऑफ सीलरी स्टेफाइलोमा, you are going to get the disease of ciliary body, you are going to get some pathology of the ciliary body, or you are going to get a trauma. So you have to read that question also combined with the clinical features and then only reach to the answer. Okay, all right. So I think all the images the PDF will be shared to you soon after the session. Don't worry, I'll just make the PDF and I'll share with you, and give me some time, I'll definitely share it with you. I hope you have understood, and I think I have answered the questions also. So good night guys, great audience, thank you for your patience, and happy ophthalmology. Goodbye, goodbye guys.